Gulls. They played just three games. He's got 7 points, 4 goals and 3 assists. He's averaging better than a goal per game and better than 2 points per game. They're going to have to keep an eye on Hubie McDonough.
All right, but for the Arrows, they've got Clayton Young flying, playing pretty good hockey right now.
Clayton Young was shut out in the opening game of the season, but has 5 points since then on 3 goals and 2 assists. We recall he had 2 goals here in the home opener. So he's been developing very well with his winger, Mike Yeo, and I look for them to combine tonight for some good scoring chances.
It's time for the Oshman's Keys to Victory, brought to you by Oshman's Super Sports USA. And tonight, Russ, defense.
Well, we've said it all along, defense is the key. You can't allow 11 goals in the last 2 games and expect to win. So Terry wants much better defense here tonight. They're clicking 20% of the time on the power play. They want to improve that tonight. They must maintain their composure. They played 4 games, 4 one-goal games, 2 of them in shootouts. When you're in those kind of close games, you got to maintain composure, and that leads us right to point number 4. You got to protect the lead. And these 2 losses we alluded to, they had leads in both games and let them get away. If they get a lead tonight, they got to hold it.
All right, thank you, Russ. Up next, we'll chat with the head coach of the Arrows, Terry Ruskowski, here on Home Sports Entertainment. Houston Arrows Hockey on HSE is brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Flying the low fare airline is just plain smart. And by Columbia HCA Healthcare Corporation, a new commitment to healthcare together.
An ordinary beer can, barely alive.
Gentlemen, we can rebuild it. We have the technology. We have the capability to make the world's first bionic can. Coors Light will be that can. Better than it was before. Taller. Thinner. Silver.
Next on the Coors Light Channel.
SWC stands for Southwest Conference. And to catch all the exciting news from Lubbock to Houston, Austin to Dallas, and all points in between, this week in the SWC is the place. Wednesday at 5:30 on HSE.
It's time to jam.
Can you dig it?
Big hits, big plays, big time emotions. Dig in for the best of the SWC. Saturday on HSE.
Welcome back to the Summit. I'm Russ Small. With me, Arrows coach Terry Ruskowski, the Arrows and the San Diego Gulls here tonight. Coach, in your last 2 games, you've allowed 11 goals. I know you want to cut down on the goals against.
That's way too many goals against us. You know, the first 2 games were fine. We, I think it was 5 in a combination or 7 in a combination of 2 games, and all of a sudden we go up to 11. It's something that's a big concern as a coach and as a team. I know our defensive game has eroded somewhat, and either the goaltending hasn't come up with a big save or the defensive not doing the job or the forwards aren't helping out in the defense. So it's a combination of all three, and we got to get that eliminated if we want to be contenders.
I'm assuming that's going to be eliminated tonight, and wouldn't it be nice to have kind of a laugher here tonight, Coach? You've had 4 games, 4 one-goal games, 2 decided in shootout. Yeah. Let's go out and blow somebody out tonight.
Well, that would be nice, but every time you think you're going to do it, you never happen. So it's always the unexpected happens all the time, and we just want to play hard hockey tonight, and we want to play a good defensive game, and hopefully that's going to cover ourselves up and we can come up with a win at least.
And Rob Dobson gets his second start in goal tonight.
Yeah, we're going to go back and forth and see how these guys are going to compete against each other and see who's going to be number one guy. So yeah, he's going back tonight. He's got to redeem himself from Atlanta, so hopefully tonight's the night he redeems himself.
Coach, good luck tonight.
Thanks, Russ.
Arrows coach Terry Ruskowski, I'm Russ Small. Adam Gordon and I'll be back to start this hockey game in just a moment.
Discover the defensive training secrets of America's finest baseball school in an exciting videotape. Baseball World's Defensive Drills video features professional scout and instructor Tom Emanski and the same revolutionary new training techniques that have produced Baseball World's back-to-back-to-back AAU National Championship teams. The Defensive Drills video vastly improves players' arm strength, running speed, quickness, agility, and infield and outfield defensive skills. Even coaches' practice organization. Lou Pavlovich, Jr., editor of Collegiate Baseball Magazine, calls it a masterpiece, the best defensive drill video ever produced. Many professional players are excited about this videotape. Just ask Atlanta Braves superstar Fred McGriff.
This is an instructional video that gives results.
Baseball World's Defensive Drills video makes a great gift and benefits players of all ages and ability levels. To order your copy for only $29.95, have your credit card ready and call toll-free. 1-800-423-2121. That's 1-800-423-2121.
It really worked for me.
Welcome back to the Summit, everybody. Adam Gordon along with Russ Smalls. We are set for the Arrows and the San Diego Gulls. In goal tonight for the Arrows, Rob Dobson, who is going to try and redeem himself a little bit here, Russ, after a tough outing in Atlanta.
It's the word used by Terry Ruskowski. Gave up 6 goals in Atlanta, and redeem it is. We're ready to go.
In goal for the San Diego Gulls, it'll be Alan Bester. We'll drop the puck. Arrows defend the goal to our right. The goal to our left, and here we go. Puck dropped into the San Diego zone. On the left side now. Mark Buffet trying to clear, cannot, back in behind the San Diego net. It's worked along the left side and swept to the line, not out. Held in by Curtis Hunt for the Arrows. Let's a wrist shot go block. That trickles just wide of the net, and now it is Barry Drager. He's pinned along the wall by Arneil. In there is Mark Ferner. He tries to roll it. Puck in behind the San Diego net. Arneil, former goal, trying to dig it out of there as well. Freer trying to lock it up. It comes out to the far corner of the net, and there was David Sacco to clear it to the line, not out. Back in behind, here is Freer, who's dumped by Drager. Barry backhands it to the line. It's back to neutral ice. We played just over 40 seconds here in this first period. No score, and Brian McKee back to his own blue line. He'll send the puck back into the San Diego zone. Here is Ferner, attacked by Arneil, who takes the puck away. Base of left circle, centered it to Clayton Young. That rolled off the stick. Drager trying to clear, cannot. Now it is Townsend for Young. Base of the left circle again. Circled back to Townsend. Now Clayton Young trying to find Mike Yeo. It rests along the left side. Yeo battles with Sacco. Yo's got the puck now for the Arrows, trying to kick it down. Yeo flipped it to the far corner on his horse. It's Valamont. Bofeg trying to clear, cannot. He's wrapped up by Valamont. Here's Mike Yeo, right side, back to a point. Young a drive and a routine stick save made by Alan Bester. He'll come out of the net, back to the line, not out. Clayton Young again, chipped it down into the far corner. Mark Ferner trying to go after it for the Gulls. He's pinned by Yeo. Now pinching is Clayton Young. Couldn't do anything with a puck, and Bofeg is there to clear it to the line, not out. Now Valamont, wrist shot right on it. A glove save made by Bester, and he'll hold on.
All the action has been here in front of Alan Bester. Hasn't had to make an awful lot of saves, but here at this end of the ice, Adam, all the action. Good job by Young when he was covering up at the point to pinch it in and keep it in the zone a couple of times. Earlier, Hunt did the same thing to the near side. So good job by the Arrows right out here off the opening faceoff to get the puck into the forward zone and keep it in there. And really a nothing night so far, early as it is for Rob Dobson. It's all but in front of Alan Bester.
Dobson coming into tonight's game with a 6.09 goals against average. He'll look to bring that down tonight. Here's Valamont off the faceoff. Let the shot go. Sizzles wide of the net. Now it's Hubie McDonough. He's the guy the Arrows have got to watch. McDonough trying to get it out of there. Cannot do it. Now back down the left side. Here's a chance for St. Cyr. He's bumped by McDonough as they're skate to skate in the near corner. In there, Dave Tippett to have a look at it as well. Now the puck picked up. Darren Van Imp and the former Prince Albert Raider from the Western League, and he played also with the Red Deer Rebels. He couldn't clear, but now it's back to the line for Shagorodsky. Let a big drive go on a glove save made by Bester. He'll hold on. 2 minutes gone by in the first scoreless hockey game.
I'm not sure, Adam, if the Arrows are just forechecking so well and covering that blue line so well, or San Diego is letting down their guard on these clearing passes, but they keep trying to fire it up along the boards. Shagorodsky this time, and I mentioned a moment ago the other guys, we've just been keeping it in at the blue line and keeping more pressure on Alan Bester. Eventually, one's going to find its way past him.
Terry Ruskowski going to utilize the home ice advantage, the fact he gets a late line change, and he'll bring out the Clayton Young line. This is not only the best offensive line right now, but it's his best defensive line. He wants it against McDonough.
Yeah, well, a faceoff coming to the circle to the right of Alan Bester, so let's get your best offensive guys right in there quickly.
Faceoff between McDonough and Young, and some jousting now between Mike Yeo and Jason Marshall, and linesmen tell him to take it easy, and we'll try it again. No score in the hockey game just underway, but as you say, Russ, it has been pretty much all Houston with the pressure. Townsend now to try and win the draw. He does. Quick shot by Young. Goes wide of the net. Picked up by Jason Marshall of the Gulls. He'll whirl it back to the right point. Here is Valamont. Spins it down. Back behind the San Diego net for Graham Townsend. Centered the puck, but it's picked away there by Brian Sullivan. He'll move it out to center ice. Now McDonough drills the puck into the Houston zone. Sullivan picks it up left side. Centered it. It'll hop to McDonough. Base of the right circle. He overskated. Valamont fell. Now a chance. Marshall centered the puck. Loach couldn't get a stick on it. And it's picked up by Valamont. He'll skate it to center ice. His cross-ice pass just eluding Townsend. Townsend. And the Gulls will try it again. Van Imp, center ice pass, picked away by Clayton Young, trying to advance the puck, cannot do it. And here's Hubie McDonough, rolled it back to his own blue line and turned around by Jason Marshall. 17 minutes, 10 seconds to play in the first. No score in this hockey game. And now it is Darren Van Imp for San Diego. Dumps the puck into the Houston zone. Dobson out of the cage to slow it for Jakes. Jakes, long lead pass out to his own blue line for Townsend. He'll roll it to the left side for Yo. And he'll gently roll it into San Diego territory after Eves, trying to pop it free. It came out in front, but it's jumped on there by Steve Bluchin. Out to center ice, picked away by Tippett. Roll it over to Eves now. Left side shoots, and his shot goes high and wide. Rebound back to Jakes. He winds, he shoots, and I think Bester may have gotten a glove on that one. And the rebound will sizzle out this center ice, and there's Chris Foy to dump it back into the San Diego zone. And we get a whistle as the Arrows are offside, and they'll bring the faceoff to center ice. Let's take a timeout. 3.5 gone by in the first. We're scoreless back after this.
This label tells you it's 100% cotton. This label tells you it's 100% real cheese. And this label tells you it's 100% low fares. Always check the label. Southwest, the low fare airline. On most airlines, you can only get a low fare to a few places. But Southwest has low fares everywhere we fly. So for low fares every time you fly, don't get stuck on some other airline. Southwest, the low fare airline.
Face-off center ice, as Eves will take it against Steve Ruchin. Drop of the puck, and it's won by San Diego, controlled by Ferner at his own blue line. Glad to have you with us tonight. I'm Adam Gordon with Russ Small, and we're scoreless here from the summit of Houston. San Diego and the Houston Arrows. Puck in the near corner now, in the Arrow zone. Here's a chance for Craig Reichert. He's pinned along the wall by Eves, working hard with Murray in the corner. They're based in the right circle. Marshall trying to center the puck and hit his skate. Now it comes out in front, and it's swept away by St. Cyr. Alert play there by Jerry to clear the puck out of harm's way. Now the puck along the left side and out to center ice. It comes to Dave Tippett. He'll bring it into the zone. We're going to get a delayed penalty coming up to the San Diego goals. It could be a tripping minor coming up as it's touched by Bester, and we'll get the first penalty of the night.
Definitely a tripping call coming up here. It happened to the right goaltender Rob Dobson, so the Arrows will get on a power play here. We talked about that in the keys to our game, that they want to upgrade their power play situation. Just 20% coming into this game. Craig Reichert, oh, they called cross-checking. Excuse us, I thought for sure it was tripping there in the corner, but they end up calling the cross-check on Reichert. Power play opportunity for the Arrows. We talked to you a moment ago about how they have been controlling the play here in the first period. Four shots on goal for the Arrows, zero for the Gulls.
Face off to the right of Bester, won by San Diego. Puck shot to the line, and John Lilly able to clear it, but not out. Now back top of the slot. It's centered. Arneal for Townsend couldn't get the shot away. It popped to the near side. Picked up by Shargorodsky. He has been on fire with a pair of goals and a pair of assists, but couldn't hold the puck in now, and Lilly is there for San Diego. He is a pretty good hockey player when it comes to shorthanded. He loves the open ice. He played on the U.S. national team, but he got the job done by working the puck back into the Arrow zone. Here's a long lead pass that just eludes Brian McKeon. It's turned around by Mark Ferner. He'll bring the puck over the Arrow blue line, trying to sidestep Shargorodsky. He's got the puck base of the right circle, and with 1:24 remaining in the penalty right now, San Diego is the one that's putting a little bit of the pressure on the Arrows, and we talked about this.
Well, it all started with a bad lead pass by Shargorodsky. Gave up the puck, and they only now have just gotten it back.
Now it's Graham Townsend as he hits the line for Houston. He'll stop hash marks right side into the San Diego zone. Back to McKee, goes to Townsend left side. Now Arneal centered that, but it just skipped over the stick of Freer. Here's the puck for Shargorodsky. Base of the left circle for Freer. Getting set, he'll work the puck, circle back to the left side. Now left point Shargorodsky, give it back to Freer. Arrows have 53 on the power play. A centering pass knocked away, and the Gulls were able to get it down the ice. The Arrows have 48 seconds left on the power play. 14:43 to play in the first. We're scoreless.
Really have only had one good scoring chance of the power play, but they've got time here for another rush up ice.
Carl Vallemont will take the puck in behind his net. He's watched by McDonough. He'll get it out to the right side, and the Arrows are able to clear. Here is Dave Tippett. He'll launch the puck into San Diego territory. Chitteroni first one there, base in the left circle, crushed along the wall by Jason Marshall. Chitteroni and Marshall now skate the skate in the near corner. Tip it in there to dig it out for the Houston Arrows. Back in behind the net. Chitteroni looking for Clayton Young. Young with a puck. He's wrapped up and takes a shoulder by Jason Marshall in the corner. Now a chance for Young as he cuts it out in front. But that's stripped by McDonough and popped out to center ice. 6 minutes gone by in the first. Still no score. Arrows power play is just about done with 3 seconds now. Here's Chitteroni. He's popped off the puck and now the penalty over. Here come the San Diego Gulls. Reichert as he just popped out of the penalty box, brings the puck in, didn't have really anyone to pass it to, so he'll just dump it deep into Houston territory. Here's Curtis Hunt now, team captain for the Arrows. He'll lob it out to center ice for Mario Cittorone. He'll drill the puck into the San Diego zone. It takes a weird hop off the glass, hits the side of the net, and Bester is able to clear it. Out to center ice, turned around by Foy, but now the goals are there. Here's Perry Drager now, his pass brought into Beaufay, dropped it for Lilly. It's tipped away to center ice. The Arrows cannot advance it, though. And the goals dump it in. Foy back. Got it out to center. Right now, the goal is doing a good job of just keeping the puck somewhat in the Houston area of ice. And finally, the Arrows are able to clear it. Here is Brian Pellerin. He'll dump the puck into the San Diego zone. Bester there to play it, and we'll get a whistle. And we'll take a timeout. 7 minutes gone by in the first. Still no score. Back right after this.
You're back at Sam Houston Race Park. Wednesday, October 12th, the season begins. The Thoroughbreds are back. More thrills, more winnings, more power. Wednesday, October 12th, the incredible Thoroughbred season returns at Sam Houston Race Park. Find out why they call it horsepower.
Gordon along with Russ Small, the Arrow power play. Well, some work still needs to be done there as the Arrows really didn't get anything accomplished on that power play.
Well, literally, we told you just as they got onto it that they had outshot the San Diego Gulls 4-0. Well, the power play's over and it's still 4-0. Not a single shot on goal during the power play.
Here's a centering pass into the center just wide by St. Cyr as Foy let that one fly. And the puck goes to center ice. It's picked up by Clark Donatelli. He'll dump the puck in. Here's a chance as Ruchin lets it fly. That goes wide of the net. Now Jakes, he's jumped all over by Donatelli. In there, Ruchin. He centered the puck. Here's the shot. Dobson down. And he's covering up. Good job by Robbie Dobson. He held the pike to the far side and makes a nice save.
Well, good job by the San Diego Gulls. They were all around in front of Dobson. Puck came out in front. Shot finally taken out in front. And Dobson makes the big save. You see good maneuvering from out behind the net. Ruchin involved in that. And Dobson, his first save of the night. But it was a good one.
Faceoff will be in the circle to the right side of Rob Dobson. 12:38 to play in the first period. Still no score in this hockey game. And here's the line of Ruchin, Donatelli, and Mike Maniluk. 21 years of age, Mike Maniluk is. Drop of the puck, and now it is controlled in the fire circle by the Arrows. Hunt couldn't clear it. Now it's Mark Freer. He'll circle away from Ruchin, and he'll move it up the right wing boards. Here comes Mark Freer now from the Houston Arrows. Right to left as he cuts it around Marshall. Freer trying to get in on goal, but he's muscled off the puck, and Van Imp able to clear it. And here come the Gulls from left to right. Maniluk, he'll speed it into the Houston zone as he hits the line. He'll backhand it into the far corner. Dobson helps redirect, but Clark Donatelli is there. And along the wall by McKee, and now the Arrows will jump on it, and they'll romp the center ice. Here come the Arrows. It's Brian Pellerin as he cuts it into the San Diego zone. Drills a shot and a stick save made by Bester. Van Imp back in behind his cage. He'll roll to the far boards, and Gulls trying to clear it to the line, not out. It's held in by McKee. Yeah, well, was it? No, hand pass. Faceoff back to center ice. We'll take a break. 11:54 to go in the first. Still no score. Back after this on the Arrows Broadcasting Network.
Name of the game is speed. Flying on steel blades across an arena of ice, stopping on a dime. Houston has a new way of flying. They're called the Arrows, and they're Houston's newest pro team. They'll be earning their wings every day. Bringing you thrills and chills will be their goal.
Sunday on HSE.
Clayton Young will come out with Graham Townsend and Dave Tippett. Defensively, Oleg Shargorodsky and Carl Vallemont. I'll tell you what, Russ, Shargorodsky has really been playing some good hockey.
Well, he certainly has tonight, I can tell you that. I know he had a pretty good weekend, and he has picked it right up here tonight, both in his defensive end and at center ice, getting the play headed the other direction.
He'll shoot the puck into the San Diego zone. It'll come back to a right point Vallemont. He tries to let a shot go, and a right pad save made by Bester. Now Clayton Young gets it back to the line. Shargorodsky, he'll shuffle it down low. Ferner trying to knock it away for San Diego. It comes out in front. Arrows trying to bang away at it, and there was Bester as he is down, and he'll smother the puck with 11 and a half to go in the first.
Oleg Shargorodsky Gostkowski talked about how well he's been playing lately in his last couple of games. Has 2 goals and 2 assists, 4 points. That includes an assist Sunday at Denver. Had a couple of goals and an assist in Atlanta on Saturday. That's sometimes what you really find out about a guy is how he plays on the road. Everybody's expected to play well at home where he's comfortable and he's got friends and he's got the home crowd for him. On the road, you see a guy play like that and you know the guy came to play.
The faceoff now. San Diego clears the puck, but not out. Here's a chance for Clayton Young, galloping, shooting, and a pad save by Bester. Here is Clayton Young now. He's wrapped up by Drager, but it's picked away for Yumi McDonough. He'll move it out to center ice for Lonnie Loke. And that pass just eludes Sullivan, and the Arrows are back to clear it. It'll go into San Diego territory. First one there, Townsend. He fell, courtesy of Scott Chartier. Here is Clayton Young now. Left circle, trying to cut in, but that'll drizzle down to Bester, and he'll cover up and hold on as we've got Townsend and Chartier talking, and nothing coming of that.
We've got 10:55 to play here in the first period. There's no score. Let me tell you about Alan Bester. He's a 9-year NHL veteran. Played for many years, was a starting goaltender for Toronto, played for Detroit as well. Although the Arrows have had the better of the play here, they really haven't had the kind of shot that's going to beat an experienced, top-notch goaltender like Alan Bester. They've had some shots on him. They've made him work, but they haven't really had an opportunity to beat him. And their shot selection and their play selection is going to have to get a little better if they're going to get one by him.
Face-off won by the Arrows. Here's point left, point shot in the left hand, save made by Bester. Now the puck picked up by the San Diego Goals, and it's Beaufay. Shoots the puck into the Arrow zone. Dobson knocked it down. He'll roll it to the near side. Chitteroni in there to dig it out. He'll sail a pass for Steve Jakes. He'll jump on it, move up the right wing boards. The center ice for St. Cyr. Lobs one ahead for Chitteroni. Knocked away by Scott Chartier, and Beaufay is there for San Diego. 10.5 to play. Get a whistle and a hand pass, and the faceoff will be brought back to center ice with 10.5 to play in the first. No score. We'll be right back after this.
Hi, Elvira here, finding great horror movies for the Coors Life Flicker Treat giveaway.
Coors!
Huh? We're giving away 50,000 videos, like the giant Gila monster, the wasp woman, or the brain that wouldn't die. Don't just stand there. Look for me this Halloween in a shocking display of specially marked Coors packages with film clips inside that tell you if you've won. The Coors Life Flicker Treat giveaway. It'll be a scream.
.10:30 to play in the first. And no score in the hockey game. Drop of the puck, and the Arrows have got it. Here is Chris Foy back to his own blue line, trying to launch one ahead for Chitteroni. Just eludes him, and Van Imp is there to clear to the line. Not out. Chitteroni again trying to get it back to the line. It's held in by Jakes. Now a chance. Chitteroni cuts into the slot, stays with the puck, and dropped it back. For Foy, he couldn't center it. It'll go to St. Cyr right side. Jerry St. Cyr lost an edge. He crashed in Vernon. We're going to get a penalty on Darren Van Imp, and then he gives St. Cyr a little extra shove after the whistle. And with 10:05 left in the first and no score, the Arrows are going to get another power play.
I won't even begin to guess what he's going to call on this one, whether it's a hook or a hold. Let's wait until they tell us all about it. I think it might be a hooking call in the corner, but either way, I can tell you that it is going to be Van Imp going out for 2 minutes. You know, we talked earlier about the power play not clicking for the Arrows, especially so at home. With the one that went by the boards earlier tonight with no shots on goal, they're now 1 of 12 at home on power plays, and I wonder if they're pressing just a little bit here before the home crowd with the man advantage, and hooking is indeed the call on Van Imp. So I had a 50-50 chance since I gave you two possibilities, and hooking it is.
Faceoff will be in the circle to the left side of Alan Bester as we start this power play with 10:05 to play in the first. Drop of the puck, Arrows win the draw. Here is McKee, and that's one thing they've had to work on, and they've done a good job tonight on the faceoff. They get that puck possession, that's half the battle. Now the puck resting in behind the San Diego net to the near side as the Gulls trying to clear it. It was Manilock. He'll get it to the line, not out. McKee tries to fix it, beat by Bester, and he'll hold on. Now Townsend again in there as he's talking matters over with Clark Donatelli, and everybody kind of meeting in there.
Good job by Graham Townsend right out in front of Bester. That shot, little flip shot, little wrist shot from the point. But Townsend was screening Bester A and got a little piece of it, B, to redirect it. But Bester stayed right with it.
Well, with the San Diego Goals in town, the director of player personnel for the Houston Arrows, Pete Dineen, as he's got his player card right there. And looks pretty good there.
Wonder what that card is worth on the open market.
Oh, I don't know. I heard millions.
I know a lot of kids used to throw the card away and just chew the bubble gum.
I got rid of the Honus Wagner card just so I could get that one. As a drive goes to the left side, it'll come back to the point. Maniluk able to clear it out to center ice. Now back is Shargorodsky. A minute and a half remaining in the penalty to Darren Van Imp. Arrows back in their own end. Here is Brian McKee. He'll dance up ice now. Off the right wing boards for Mark Freer. He'll turn to his left, bring the puck in now. Nice pass. Opportunity tonight for the Arrows, and Shargorodsky just glanced one wide of the net. Now the puck in behind the San Diego cage. Here is Freer trying to find it. Scott Arneil. Arneil's got it. Roll it back to the right point. McKee on his horse trying to hold it in. He did so, but now he fell, and there is Mike Maniluk for the San Diego goals. He'll bring the puck in. Wine, let the shot go. That's blocked by McKee, and that'll go up and out of play. With 8:57 left in the first, no score, 53 seconds remaining in the Van Imp minor.
We talked about Oleg Shargorodsky on a pretty good streak lately, a couple of goals, a couple of assists, 4 points in his last two games. He had a good chance here in the power play coming down and getting off a good shot from the circle. Went short side with it, Adam, and the short side was there. Bester had come out for an angle, but he gave up some of the short side, and so he went after that short side to the right of Alan Bester, right from about the dot near low in the circle, and had him beat, but missed the net. Good opportunity right there.
Face off now will be to the top of the near circle, which is to the left of Rob Dobson. McDonough, Loach. And defensively, they'll line up with Marshall and Chartier. Now off the faceoff, here is Curtis Hunt. Had it popped away by Loach, but it came right to Vallemont. Up the left side for Tippett. Dancing down the left side, shoots the puck into the San Diego zone. Eaves run off the biscuit. Now the puck in front. Clayton Young turns with a shot, stopped by Bester. It was a weak one, and Bester had to handle it, though, and it's picked up by Chartier. Long lead pass for Lonnie Loach. That'll roll off the stick. It'll go down to Dobson. He'll redirect it into the corner. First one there is Loach trying to center it. That hit a leg. Now the puck picked up. Here's McDonough. Top of the slot. Marshall. Wayne shoots. And Vallemont there to get a stick on it. That puck is out of play. Let's take a timeout with 8:24 left in the first. We're scoreless. Back after this on the Arrows Broadcasting Network.
Where do you go when you want to have fun?
I'm out on the course every chance I get.
And Little League and basketball and football.
I go fishing with my grandson.
But first, we go to Oshman Super Sports.
Where I can try all the newest clubs right here in the store.
This store is bigger than Lake Travis.
One store has all the fun. Oshman Super Sports.
Welcome back to the Summit in Houston. Adam Gordon along with Russ Small, and both teams have had their chances. And there's 20 seconds left on the power play. And the Arrows win the draw. No score in the hockey game. Puck in behind the arrow net, and here comes Chris Foy. He'll bring it out to center ice for Tippett. Up the right wing now. Tippett in over the blue line, looking for Clayton Young. Lost the puck. Marshall's there. On the left side, here's a pass back to the point. Here's a drive. Right on. Missed rebound. Mr. Got it. Oh, my. Eaves redirected one. I think he was trying to bounce one off the back of Bester, and it just went wide of the net. Now Tippett along the far side, looking for Eaves. He collides with Chartier. In there, Clayton Young now. He skates the skates, got the puck. Power play now over. Teams at five aside. Eaves hustling in there. Here's Young, base of the right circle, trying to shake off the check of Beaufay. He's got it down into the far corner. Marshall there for San Diego. Tipped the puck along the half court. Tell you what, though, in the first 12 minutes or so of this hockey game, the Arrows definitely working with just that much harder, I think, than San Diego, although San Diego's had their chances. Here's a pass center ice, and Beaufay has to go back. It is controlled now, San Diego. Mark Beaufay, head man pass, hit the way to center. Yo trying to move it ahead. There's Foy there, but finally San Diego able to dump it in. Here's Shargorodsky at his own blue line. He'll move it from right to left and rip it into the San Diego zone. Bester knocked it down. Puck facing right circle. Mike Yo cuts it behind the net.
Great saves by Bester as the Arrows put a lot of pressure on around him. First the wraparound opportunity by Mike Yo. Yo gets it back again, tries another backhander with Cittaroni right on the doorstep, and Bester was equal to it. Best chance of the night, though, came a few moments ago. Murray Eaves looking at a wide open net, but a puck on edge and bouncing a little bit. He tried to bounce it in and couldn't quite get control of it. They've been putting pressure on Bester.
The face-off, here's Mike Yo. Quick shot and a right pat save, beat by Bester again. Bester's been tested here in this first period, but he's come up fine. Now Pellerin sends it back, but it's intercepted by Brian Sullivan. He'll move it to center, trying to move around Hunt. Now the puck resting into the between the circles is taken away by McDonough. A drive stop by Dobson. The rebound launched high over the net. Old Dobson made the first save, but he got a bit lucky on the second one. The Arrows finally will shoot it up and out of play with 6:40 left in the first. And a scoreless hockey game, but we're back after this on the Arrows Broadcasting Network.
The older they are, the harder they hit. The Champions Tour takes to the courts with more than just players. We're talking legends. Wednesday night on HSE. The world's finest golfers challenge Europe's most prestigious and unpredictable courses. Witness the memories and magic of the European PGA. The Alfred Dunhill Cup, Friday night at 9 on HSE.
Face off to the right of Dobson, scoreless hockey game.
Big save by Dobson a moment ago on Hubie McDonough and Brian Sullivan combining out in front for good opportunity, but Dobson was sharp.
Puck controlled by the Arrows. Here's Mark Freer. He'll glance one in behind his own net. Foy there to gather it in, and now it is Arneal. He'll roll it out to center, but Ferner turns it around for San Diego. Hubie McDonough, give it to Sullivan. Tipped it ahead for Loach. Looking for Sullivan. It's tipped away and back out to center ice. Arneal watching his former linemate in Hubie McDonough. And now the puck picked up by Lonnie Loach. Headman pass for McDonough off the mark, and Jerry St. Cyr will hustle back to his own blue line for the Houston Arrows. No score in this hockey game. 6:09 left in the first. Here is McDonough. Takes a whack by St. Cyr, but stays top of the puck. He'll leave it in behind now for Ferner. Gulls move it from left to right. Mark Ferner up the left side. It's tipped along the boards by Drager. Out to center. Picked back by Foy at his own blue line. And the Arrows. Foy trying to just shoot it down, and that'll go all the way down the ice. No icing, as they felt Marshall could have played that off that line change, and he'll turn it around. 5:44 left in the first. Still no score in this hockey game. The Arrows have definitely had their chances, and I feel they've had quite a few more than the San Diego Gulls. Here is Marshall. He'll turn it up now for Ruchin. Up the left side. Donatelli dropped it back for Ruchin. Left side, left circle now. It's dropped back for Van Imp. Lets a shot go, and Dobson there to cover up with 5:23 left in the first. Still no score.
A couple of nice drop passes by the Gulls. They couldn't quite take it into the net, so they took it and worked an angle and dropped it back once and then dropped it back twice and got a shot away that was not on goal. You talk about line mates a moment ago. We got a couple of guys who were teammates and skated together a few years back when they were just young teenagers, about 14 years old. Lonnie Loach of the San Diego Gulls and Mario Cittaroni of the Houston Arrows. So they go back quite a ways, and the Arrows with quite a lead and shots on goal.
There's one right there from the left point, and Dobson easily down to make the save.
14-2, shots on goal.
Here's the puck now, picked up McKee, couldn't clear. Hunt redirects far corner, but Donatelli beats him to the puck. Donatelli back to the left point. It's held in there by Mark DeSantis. He rolls it to Donatelli. Lost his lumber, and the puck will go to the near side, and Curtis Hunt will pick it up. Left wing board, center ice, tipped it to Townsend, lost the handle. DeSantis can't do anything with it, and the Arrows dump the puck back in. Clayton Young does the honors. Now Bester out of the net. He'll flip it high off the glass. It'll go to the line. Not out. McKee held it in. He'll shovel it down low, trying to find Townsend. Young shoulder to shoulder with Chartier. And it is DeSantis. Get it back to a left point. Chargorodsky, his wrist shot, a weak one that'll bounce to the near corner. Picked up by Townsend. He looks along the wall. And it's stripped by Chartier and throws it into the scrum. It'll come back to the left point. Chargorodsky held the puck in nicely once again. Here's Chartier again. Chips the puck in the corner. Townsend being muscled pretty good down on the ice by DeSantis, but play just goes right on. Here come the San Diego Gulls. Ruchin dumps the puck in. Dobson comes out of the net, and he flipped it over the glass, and that might be a penalty. I think it didn't hit the glass, and when we return, we may get a San Diego penalty. 4:13 left in the first. We're scoreless back after this.
My darling, I have procured a delicious meal. It's a shrimp and fish meal from Long John Silver's. Three tasty battered dip shrimp and their famous fish.
The Little Rascals, now playing at theaters in a Long John Silver's near you.
It's time to jam.
Can you dig it?
Vandy is looking to stop Georgia as the Dogs are whooping with Sire in an SEC battle between the hedges. Vanderbilt battles Georgia live Saturday at 11:30 on HSE.
Welcome back. Adam Gordon along with Russ Small in a scoreless hockey game. Arrows are going to be shorthanded here.
Well, they're going to call delay a game on Rob Dobson. He tried to clear the zone with the puck, and if you can fire it off the boards or off the glass, that's fine. But if you just flip it right up high over the glass and into the seats, the official ruling by the referees is that, you weren't trying to clear it. You were trying to send it into the seats. They make that judgment call, and they slap you with a delay a game, and so it is. It's called in the goalie, but somebody else will sit out the 2 minutes for him.
First look at the power play for San Diego. A drive and stick save made by Dobson. Puck along the right wing boards. Half side. Now back to the line. Here's a drive by Ferner. That ricocheted wide. Here's another drive and Dobson down to get that one. And Tippett turns it around and gets it down the ice. One thing, Russ, is that the Arrows have been good on their penalty killing.
Yes, they have. They've been outstanding. They're among the best in the league right now, penalty killing, allowing about 13% efficiency to the opposition. The Arrows 0 for 2 tonight in power plays. This is the first chance for San Diego.
And there's a minute and a half remaining in the minor to Dobson. Here's McDonough back in behind the net, trying to center, but Shigarovsky is there to clear it down the ice. 1:22 remaining in the Dobson minor, 3.5 remaining in the first. No score in the hockey game. Here comes David Sacco now, in over the line, and uh-oh, here's Valamon, who got a stick high, and that'll be 2 minutes for him. So once again, the discipline bug will bite the Arrows here. They're going to be two men down, and they're going to have to go to work, and we'll bring you that two-man advantage when we return. No score from the Summit in Houston. We're back after this.
The name of the game is speed. Flying on steel blades across an arena of ice, stopping on a dime. Houston has a new way of flying. They're called the Arrows, and they're Houston's newest pro team. They'll be earning their wings every day. Bringing you thrills and chills will be their goal.
Sunday on HSE.
No score in the hockey game, and Russ, here's why the Arrows are shorthanded two men.
It's a high stick on Carl Valamont. You're just not allowed to get that stick up into somebody's face. So he goes off for two. There's still a minute and 12 left on the Dobson penalty. So the Arrows are in a heap of trouble here.
Off the faceoff, the Gulls have got it. On the left point now, here's Mark Ferner. Give it back to Loach. To Ferner, top of the slot. Gulls in no hurry. They'll patiently cycle it around now. Here is McDonough centered. That hit a leg, and Dobson down. He thought he had it, and yeah, okay, there he did. I wasn't sure, and Bernie DeGrace, our referee, says, yeah, you had it. We'll blow play dead.
Came out pretty quickly, but when the officials lose sight of it, they blow the whistle. Good job by Dobson. Among the penalty killers at the moment, Mark Freer for the Arrows, and he has a shorthanded goal to his credit this year, a shorthanded goal and a power play goal. Right now, though, the Arrows not thinking shorthanded goal. When you're down 5-on-3 on the ice, you're just thinking, let's protect our goaltender, let's clear it at every opportunity, and let's get out of the next couple of minutes still even up in the game. 3:11 to play, first period, no score.
Face-off to the right of Dobson. Gulls win another key face-off. Here's a chance now as it comes back left point. Ferner down low for Loach. Looks in behind the net. Now McDonough centered. Here's the drive. It was fanned on it. Trickled to the far corner. Loach couldn't find the handle. He'll get it back. Left side now. Lonnie Loach sets up the power play. 43 left in the two-man advantage. Back to the line, Ferner to a right point. Here's a chance. A drive blocked by Dobson as there was David Sacco to let that go. And Dobson will cover up with 38 seconds remaining in the two-man advantage. A minute 26 remaining in the Valamont high stick. 2:50 left in the first. We're scoreless.
And a good play by Oleg Shigarovsky, who was right out in front of the net. He could have turned quickly and gotten his stick on that puck and tried to stop it, but that's the goaltender's job. He could easily have accidentally deflected it by his goaltender. If they're in a situation where the goaltender can see the shot all the way, it's best off if your defenseman will just let the goaltender take it. That's what he gets paid for. Don't be trying to deflect things out in front. So he backed off, let it go. Dobson made the save.
Off the faceoff, Arrows won it, but they couldn't clear it. Now the San Diego goals. David Sacco, left point. Ferner walks in, rolls it down. Loach centered it to McDonough. Couldn't get the shot away, though, and now Sacco again to Ferner, top of the slot. Wide, shoots right on. That was deflected, and now it is Loach again. Base of the left circle. 19 on the two-man advantage. Puck top of the slot. Ferner redirects it down. Here's a pass. Back to a point. Sacco getting set. Rating. Now back to the line. Ferner rolls rolls it down, a centering pass. That hit Dobson, I believe, and now back to a left point for Ferner. 2:18 left in the period. Still no score. Sacco walks right in, shoots, trying to go top jump to the far side. It's knocked away, went wide. Now the puck is, the penalty, first penalty is over. 5-on-4 for San Diego. They've got 41 on the power play. Here is Ferner, wide, shoots. Great defensive play by Aaron Eales. He went down and blocked that one, and Ferner had to retreat back to center.
They're playing well in front of Dobson, and when he's had to, he's made the big save.
Here's another chance as they walk right in. A centering pass, and Dobson kicks that out of there. Here is Hunt. He'll get it down the ice, and a fine play with 20 seconds left to kill off. 1:45 left in the period, and we're still scoreless.
San Diego's done a good job as the Arrows forecheck a little bit. San Diego's done a good job setting it up, but the Arrows doing a good job taking away the good angles.
Now down the left side, Van Imp. 8 seconds on the power play, trying to center it. That was worked away. The puck left point. It was centered, but it comes back to Jason Marshall. A weak shot rolled away, and the penalty. Allen nearly killed the two automatic. Now Lilly rolls it down. A centering pass blocked. And there is Foy. He'll glance that off the glass and down the ice. This will be icing, but I'll tell you what, the Arrows will take that with 1:10 remaining in the period and no score. A bit of a standing ovation. Fine job there.
And on the season now, we talked about the proficiency of the Arrows penalty killing. Now 22 of 25 penalties on this young season they have killed. That was a terrific job killing off a long two-man disadvantage, and even the one-man advantage that San Diego had for a little bit there was outstanding for San Diego, and outstanding penalty killing by the Arrows, who still enjoy the shots on goal advantage, 14-9. It wasn't at 14-2 a little bit ago. The last seven shots in this hockey game belong to San Diego.
A lot of it on that power play, but Dobson holding his ground. Off the faceoff. Here's Van Imp, top of the slot. His shot goes just wide of the net. Now Jake's far corner, get it up to Townsend. He's bumped off the puck, but he got it back to center ice, and Jason Marshall back to his own blue line. Got it up for Van Imp. Mike Maniloff trying to turn it around, and we're under a minute to go here in the first period, and no score. Now it's Beaufay. He lost an edge, crashed and burned along the wall, but Vallemont's there to get it into San Diego territory. Pester out of the net now. He'll slow the puck for the first one back. It was Marshall. He'll get it out to center ice. 38 seconds left in the period as Vallemont on his horse to pick up the puck. He'll rumble in behind his net, stop on a dime, and away he will come. Carl Vallemont rolls it out to the right side for Jakes. Rink wide pass picked up by Clayton Young. Through the neutral zone he comes, but he was shouldered off the puck, and back goes Townsend. 22 seconds left in the period. No score in this hockey game, but boy, it's been a very entertaining first period. Oleg Shugorodsky now in behind his net. Roll it to the far side, Jakes. He'll just pummel it all the way down the ice. It'll be icing as the goals get back. Ferner to touch. And the faceoff will be brought back into Arrows territory with 6 seconds remaining in this first period. We're scoreless here, and tell you what, I realize one period a hockey game does not make, but when you're trying to put bits and pieces back to your defense, I think Terry Ruskowski has got to be pleased with the way his defense has played. Number one. Number two, the penalty killing has taken over where it left off as it killed off that 5-on-3. And, you know, San Diego, definitely no slouch on the power play when you're talking about Loach and Sacco and McDonough. And the Arrows did a fine job of killing that off. Faceoff will be to the right of Dobson. Kind of a key faceoff here if the Arrows can win it. And they do. Here's Eaves. Hustles in behind the net. 3 seconds left in the period. He'll sail it in behind the net. Shugorodsky to touch, and the buzzer sounds, ending the opening period of play. Teams. The Gulls got off to kind of a slow start as the Arrows picked up the pressure and really put it to Alan Bester. But boy, things turned around, and it turned out to be an excellent period, really, for both hockey teams. So we play 20 minutes here from the Summit in Houston, and our score after the first period, it's the Arrows nothing and the Gulls nothing. We'll have more right after this.
There's your champion for you.
Raymond Floyd, winner of 31 PGA Tour events.
Hi, I'm Raymond Floyd. I'm hitting the ball farther now than at any time in my career, and I'm convinced it's because of the flexibility and strength routine I started 10 years ago. I believe you too can benefit from a program specially designed to exercise the muscles important to the golf swing. Fit for Golf exercises will increase your flexibility and strength and improve your ability as a golfer to play longer and stronger each day. It's an easy workout program for all ages designed to increase both flexibility and strength. Fit for Golf is a great gift for a spouse, parent, or a professional associate, and it costs less than the price of a dozen good golf balls.
To order your video, call 1-800-327-9994 or send $19.95 plus $4.95 for shipping and handling to the address on your screen.
The Best Team Outdoors features the best block of outdoor programming in the Southwest. A group of the finest sportsmen ever assembled to help you catch more fish, have better hunts, and enjoy the great outdoors. True sportsmen practice catch and release, conservation, and preservation of nature. But they bring something home as well. A great time.
October? Well, check out HSE's October lineup. The Arrows and Stars pull out the blades to carve up the ice.
Sherman.
The Southland, SWC, SEC, and Pac-10 look to throw some treats and hand out some tricks. And the women of the SWC are bringing out the spice.
Yikes!
Still looking for some thrills? Well, tune in to HSE in October.
Okay, sorry. Welcome back to the Summit in Houston. First period intermission. The Houston Arrows and the San Diego Gulls are scoreless. I'm Adam Gordon along with Russ Small, and a very entertaining period of hockey for sure, as the Arrows first 7-8 minutes were good at 7 or 8 minutes. They put the pressure to Alan Bester, but he was there to answer the call and made some good saves. What kind of turned things around for the San Diego Gulls were the power play situation. At one point, the Arrows had outshot the Gulls at 14-2, but when you look at the final totals, 14-9 after a period of play, and I would say of those seven shots on goal there, that differential, a lot of them came on that two-man advantage. But we talked about the fact that the Arrows have the third best penalty killing in the IHL coming into tonight's game, and they showed why, not killing off one but a two-man disadvantage, and they did a fine job doing that, especially when you're talking about the likes of a Hubie McDonough out there and a Lonnie Loach. They were able to do that. Quickly, I want to run through some scores in the first period. Kansas City leading Phoenix 2-1, and also in the first period, Minnesota looking to win against Atlanta. They are up by a score of 1-0. But let's go downstairs to Russ Small. He's standing by with Clayton Young.
Adam, thank you very much. Scoreless in the first period. Clayton Young, I said before the game that on the little goal scoring streak you're on, we look for you to score one or two tonight. So far, you haven't come through for me, but you got 40 minutes left.
Yeah, they're playing pretty tough defense right now. You know, I think we can go out there, keep working hard. You know, Bester's made some pretty good saves out there. He's a great goalie. He's been in the league for a long time. So if we keep peppering him, hopefully we'll get a couple on.
I made the point earlier that with a guy like Alan Bester, you're just not going to get an easy shot by him. If you put a shot by him and you get a goal, you're going to earn it. But if he can see the puck, he's going to stop it.
Yeah, usually it's a rebound or something. He's a very steady goalie. Their defense are really standing us up right now. So like I said, if we keep going out there and shooting the puck, hopefully we can get a few rebounds or someone can get one by him, get on his confidence.
The penalty killing has been great through the early part of this season for the Arrows. Never more so than during a two-man disadvantage late there in the first period. Why the penalty killing so strong?
I don't know. It's something we've worked on a little bit, but not a lot. But we just go out there and try to pressure them and keep the puck to the outside. So if we can keep doing that, and then Dauber made a few big saves for us. So if that happens, hopefully we'll keep doing that all year.
You feel Rob Dobson wanted to redeem himself a little bit? I think he blames himself for a couple of the goals in Atlanta.
You can't really blame Dauber for those. You know, we played very, very weak defensively as a team. So, you know, Dauber is a great goalie, so is Troy Gamble. So if we give them a little help, I think that they'll be great for us all year.
We've talked about the penalty killing. We've talked about the goaltending. But how about the power play? I know that's not as efficient as you'd like it to be.
The first three games, our power play is pretty good. I think we're third in the league. But, you know, we're trying some new units out there. And, you know, it's just a trial and error basis right now. So hopefully we can get that on track right now.
All right, Clayton, good luck next couple of periods. We expect a winner here tonight.
Thank you very much.
All right, that's Clayton Young. I'm Russ Small. Adam Gordon will join me, and we'll be back right after this.
When you watch the Weather Channel, you get the most accurate and convenient weather forecast available. But weather changes, and those changes do affect your plans. So add cable and the Weather Channel to every one of your TV sets. Get tomorrow's forecast just before you go to sleep. Check it before you leave in the morning, or keep it handy throughout the day. Clearly, additional cable hookups add convenience to your life. Get the Weather Channel anytime. Call your cable operator today and add cable to every TV.
Hi, I'm Larry Forehand. At Casa Olay, you'll taste the delicious difference in our food from the very first bite. Everything at Casa Olay is prepared fresh at each location. Try our tasty chili con queso made with 100% real American cheese, beans and rice prepared fresh daily, and what can I say about our crisp chips and hot sauces? You guessed it, made fresh every day. Now that's a fabulous start to a great meal. So the next time you crave great Mexican food, taste the difference. Casa Olay, fresh today.
It's time to jam.
Can you dig it?
It's time to jam with college football all season on HSE.
Can you dig it?
It's time to jam.
Can you dig it?
Big hits, big plays, big time emotions. Dig in for the best of the SWC. Saturday on HSE.
It's time to jam.
Can you dig it?
All right, we're number one.
No way, we're number one.
You guys stink.
Better than you.
We'll see about that.
Arizona battles Washington State live Saturday at 5:30 on HSE.
Welcome back to the Summit in Houston. Adam Gordon along with Russ Small. A scoreless hockey game as we're in the first period intermission of tonight's hockey game. And Russ, we talked about the keys to victory in the defense tonight, and obviously it looked like after that first period the Arrow defense was there.
Well, the 14-9 shots on goal total doesn't really say it. The fact is, in a two-man disadvantage there late in the period is where San Diego got most of their shots on goal, about seven in a row there. At one point it was 14-2. So the defense was pretty good, and they had some good opportunities on Alan Bester. Bester came up with some saves, as you see there. A couple of good ones on Mike Yeo. Rob Dobson matched him at the other end. He had some big saves as well. And defense isn't just performed by the defensemen. Sometimes the forwards play some pretty good defense, as we see Scott Arneal with a sliding block up high near the blue line. So you got to get the forwards to help out on defense, too.
Yeah, for the Houston Arrows, though, their power play, they're 0-for-2 in that first period. It looks like they might need to reestablish that in the second period.
I think they definitely do. I think they're pressing a little bit. We talked with Clayton Young about it in the intermission. They're just not up to snuff on the power play. They're at about 18%. That's significantly below where they'd like to be. So they need to come up with the power play, but don't lose anything in the shorthanded situation, because that has been outstanding.
Yeah, it was an excellent first period for both hockey teams. And again, we need to reiterate the fact that Rob Dobson seems to be playing a lot better. You know, sometimes a goalie will come back thinking about his last performance in Atlanta. This is not the case for Dobson.
Well, he's got a shutout going in the first period. Unfortunately, so does the other guy. A good first period, a 14-9 shots on goal total favoring Houston, so there were plenty of good scoring chances, and not all the scoring chances resulted in shots on goal. There were plenty of chances that went just wide. They aren't shots on goal, but they're good scoring chances. So both teams had opportunities. Both goaltenders made the big saves, and a real good first period of hockey here tonight.
Yeah, and realistically speaking, I don't think either coach Walt Kyle for the San Diego Golds or Terry Ruskowski is going to change anything for that second period.
Well, if Terry came in here thinking that what he wanted to see was better defense out of his team, I think he saw it. And on the other end of the ice, he saw plenty of good scoring chances. So I think he's got to be happy. He just needs a few goals here to win this game.
All right. Scoreless hockey game here in the first period intermission, and we'll have more from the Summit in Houston right after this.
We'll go back to the Houston Arrows San Diego Gulls game in just a moment. Right now, let's check in with the Southwest Airlines Sports Break. I'm Kevin Eschenfelder. Well, Monday, the Texas Rangers hired themselves a new general manager. Here on Wednesday, they're looking for a new field manager.
Not going to retain the services of Kevin Kennedy as manager of the Texas Rangers. And I notified Kevin this morning. He met me here at 8:30 this morning. And we met yesterday, as you're well aware of. And we had very good conversation, and it was a lot of philosophical things. I think Kevin's got an opportunity to be a good manager in the big leagues. My gut feeling after staying in the office last night till 10 o'clock, I just felt that my gut feeling was that I wanted to start with a clean slate.
So new GM Doug Melvin wasting no time. I'm Kevin Eschenfelder in the clubhouse. This has been a Southwest Airlines Sports Break. Stay with us in a moment. We go back to the hockey game.
Thorpe. Thorpe gets around and slams it home.
Marlin picks it in on the drive. Oh, Elijah Wah. Oh, my goodness.
HSE, the best team on TV.
When you want the real story, go to the clubhouse. Get into the action and discuss the hottest topics with informed hosts and some of sports' biggest names. Live on Clubhouse Special Edition. Monday nights at 7 on HSE.
It's time to get pumped, because Larry North is ready to help you get into a healthier body. Whether you're young or old, isn't it about time you got fit? Weekday mornings at 7 on HSE.
Welcome back to the Summit. I'm Russ Small with Adam Gordon. Scoreless after one period here with the Arrows and the San Diego Gulls. You know, we got another big game in this town tomorrow night. The Houston Oilers will be playing the Cleveland Browns. The Oilers tonight, I'm sure, are thinking football. But last Friday night, as the Arrows were opening their season here at the Summit, some of the Oilers were thinking hockey. And our Barry Warner was roaming the crowd and talking with some of them.
For the Oilers, number 55, offensive left guard John Flannery. You're no stranger to hockey. You're from Pennsylvania. Did you grow up as a Flyers fan?
Yeah, the old Flyers when they were rough and tough, and back with Bobby Clark, and they got some Stanley Cup championships there. And then lately, I've been a Penguins fan.
Now, John, you got to admit one thing. In football, you get time off, you get to go to a huddle. These guys go a minute and a half straight without a break. Could you do that?
I don't think so. These guys are a lot better shape than I ever am.
What's it take, though, from the standpoint of the toughness and the speed that you, sitting here as a lineman, identify with these athletes?
I just think that the closeness of everything and the enclosed quarters and the physicalness, I guess you could compare a hockey game to a lot of what goes on in the trenches between the offense and defensive linemen.
Yeah, except these guys go from offense to defense to offense to defense. The only time you make a tackle is if there's an interception.
That's why I said they're in a lot better shape than I am.
John, do you identify with these guys? Do you look at them and say, look at a defenseman and say, that's like one of my teammates who plays linebacker, because they got to go forward and also have to have the ability to go back?
I tell you what, I think, whether they're, center, defenseman, or whatnot, I think, they're what we call in football a skill position. They got to do both, and they got to be light on their feet and agile and quick and have great stamina. So, they're pretty much little dynamo packages. They got to do it all.
Now, John, for years, the 4 years you've been down here, you have given me lots of grief. I now hereby challenge you to put on some skates and go out to the aerodrome and try to skate with me.
Mouth, if you can find 14s, I'll be more than happy to meet your challenge.
I'll find the 14s. Our equipment manager, Bill Brown, will get him. Do I hear after the season, John Flannery, wearing Arrow jersey number 55, will meet me at center ice?
Full contact, right? All body checking allowed.
Of course.
And I'll catch you.
Folks, there's no way he'll ever be able to catch me.
Thanks a lot, Barry, and I'll tell you what, I've been in this game for a lot of years, but I've seen a lot of things, but nothing I've ever wanted to see more is Barry Warner out at center ice with that guy. We're scoreless here in the first period intermission. We'll look at the first period stats right after this on the Arrows Broadcasting Network.
If you're still struggling with a wheelbarrow or a back-straining garden cart, call this number for complete details about the revolutionary DR Power Wagon. Yes, with a DR Power Wagon, you can haul heavy, bulky loads with never-before ease and take on those projects you've been putting off for years. Rocks, firewood, gravel and building materials, hay bales, and garden supplies. That dump body makes for easy unloading, and the optional sulky even lets you ride. You can haul up to 800 pounds uphill or down through soft soil and muck, even into places you wouldn't dare take a rider. You'll be amazed at what the DR Power Wagon can help you accomplish around your home, business, or property. Call toll-free 1-800-592-1222 for your big free package all about the revolutionary DR Power Wagon, plus special savings now in effect. That's 1-800-592-1222 for free DR details.
Sharpen and lace them up, because it's time to drop the puck and start skating. As Brute presents Hockey Week gives you the goals, saves, and hits you may have missed or want to see again. Face off, Fridays at 6 on HSE. SWC stands for Southwest Conference. And to catch all the exciting news from Lubbock to Houston, Austin to Dallas, and all points in between, this week in the SWC is the place. Wednesday at 5:30 on HSE.
Welcome back to the Summit in Houston. First period intermission. The Gulls nothing, the Arrows nothing. Adam Gordon along with Russ Small. Let's take a look at tonight's first period stats brought to you by James Coney Island Restaurants. And Russ, 14-9, the shots on goal, again, kind of dictating not a bad period for the Arrows.
No, it's a pretty good period, but I think, you know, San Diego coming in here, they got to be pleased as well. The first several minutes of that first period belong to the Arrows. I mean, the first 3 minutes were all in the zone in front of Alan Bester. He had to make some saves. He had to be on his toes the whole time. That whole first 3 minutes was inside the blue line, and they escaped that three-minute period. They escaped the first period scoreless in a period in which the Arrows took some control. So I think San Diego's got to be pleased to be scoreless. Terry Ruskowski and the Arrows, while not pleased necessarily with the score, have to be pleased the way they played. They played some good defense. Dobson came back off the bad performance of the weekend with a good first period, and the shooters had good chances at the other end. All in all, I think both teams are pleased, and when both teams are pleased, it's pretty even, and you can't get any more even than 0-0.
No, and you look at the power plays also. Both teams 0 of 2 on the power play. However, I think when you look at the San Diego power play, and you talked about kind of the composure element there, in the sense that sometimes teams will sense a panic when you're down two guys thinking, oh my gosh, what are we going to do? But the Arrows went ahead and let the Gulls move the puck around, but they kept it on the perimeter. And like you mentioned, they didn't give them the close and angle shots.
And they didn't give them the rebounds. That's the key. When you're down 5-on-3, they're going to get some shots. You can't cover five guys with three. And as much as you try to take the angles away from them, you're not going to get all the angles, so they're going to get some shots. What you hope for is that their shots from further out, that their shots your goaltender sees all the way, and that he either can control or you can clear. So the Arrows stayed pretty well in their triangle with one man out high and two men down low, so that when the shot was taken, one of the down low guys can clear it away, or Dobson can tie it up. And so they did a real fine job. They kept their composure, they stayed within themselves, and they killed off the two-man disadvantage.
One thing to mention also is you come into the second period, Russ. This has not been a good period for the San Diego Gulls this season. So far, they have been outscored in the second period 9-2. So perhaps if the Arrows can get a few, then maybe we'll see how they play with the lead.
Well, you know, so far they haven't played with the lead too well. In the last couple of games, they blew a third period lead in one of the games. They had a 3-1 lead in the Denver game, and that didn't hold up. So, yeah, I'd much rather be playing from ahead than playing from behind. But the key is not who leads in the middle of the second period. It's who leads at the end of 60 minutes of play.
Yeah, let's take a look at the standings in the Central Division. That's the division the Houston Arrows are in. And, boy, those Milwaukee Admirals flying at 3-0.
Well, you know, nobody's beating them. They got 6 points out of six possible points. So everybody's shooting at Milwaukee. Kansas City off to a pretty good start. Atlanta, the defending champions, defending Turner Cup champions, then the Arrows, and then the Minnesota. Arrows still in a pretty good spot. I mean, 1-2-1 record, not too bad. They got 3 points after four games, and those one-goal games, a couple have gotten away from them. But this, the second game of a three-game homestand, they definitely need to win tonight, come back, win a game again on Sunday, and get something rolling as they start to head out onto some more road games.
When you look at the Northern Division, it is stacked with a lot of talent, especially when you look at the Detroit Vipers. Yeah, they have one loss, but I think they're going to be the team to beat with all the quote-unquote ex-NHL talent they've got.
Well, and they're going crazy for hockey in Detroit. Detroit. They love their Red Wings in the National Hockey League, and now they love this team as well in the International League. And I think quite a little rivalry will be established between Detroit and Kalamazoo, especially a couple of teams just a couple hours apart, and both in the state of Michigan. I think there'll be quite a rivalry there. Hey, we're ready to go. Second period, scoreless.
We dropped the puck, and we're underway with the second period. We start at 5-a-side and zeros aside. Arrows nothing, Gulls nothing. Glad to have you with us. I'm Adam Gordon with Russ Small, and the Gulls will start with a puck in their own end. Pass to center ice for Mark Buffet. He'll get it out to center. Now down the left side, Lilly brings the puck in. Comes back, Lilly, quick shot, missed wide. Rebound, Buffet, trying to redirect one in there. And Dobson got a left pad on that one. Now Lilly creams Hunt along the wall. It'll sizzle to the near side, and Brian Pellerin is there. He'll scoop it out to center ice. Back is Mark Ferner. He'll lob the puck ahead. It's brought back in by the Gulls. Down the right side, here's Sacco looking in behind. Sacco stuffed it. It hit the pad and went into the net. They score. That took a weird hop, and we'll have to see who gets credit for the goal. But 40 seconds into the second period, Gulls lead it 1-0.
I think Sacco's going to get credit for the goal. We're just going to have to wait and see who it hit out in front. It was just popped right in front off a defenseman to the left of Dobson, off the inside of the post and in. And Adam, you just got through. You're the kiss of death, babe. You just got through saying San Diego's been outscored 9-2 in second periods this year. And what do they do in the first 30 seconds? They have a good scoring opportunity. And then at the 42nd mark of this period, they put one in. And man, just keep quiet with that kind of stuff.
I don't know if that was Sacco or Vanzetti, but regardless, it's 1-0. All right, we're back to action here in the second period. I wanted to say that. Sorry.
Mark Beaufait, the goal.
So they say Beaufait gets it as the puck brought back in, and it's shot out to center ice. So a 1-0 hockey game. The Gulls get the first goal, and here is Lonnie Loach at center, worked on by Valamont. Puck brought back in, but Loach is there to work it out the neutral ice. It'll slide into the arrow zone. Dobson comes out of the net. He'll slow it for Oleg Shargorodsky. We're a minute into the second period. Gulls lead it 1-0. Now up the left side. Yo, cross ice pass. Not a good one as it's intercepted by Sullivan. And the Gulls will start back in their own end. Clear it to the line. Loach couldn't get it out to center. Young held it in, but a second effort is pounded out the neutral ice. Back into the arrow zone. It will go for Carl Valamont. And he will turn in front of his own goaltender, Rob Dobson, and slip it out the neutral ice. Here is Darren Van Imp. Hooked it back into his own zone for Jason Marshall, the center for Loach. That's knocked down. Collision between Yo and Young. And Van Imp will say, fine, I'll take the puck. And shoot it out to center ice for Lonnie Loach. Hits the puck ahead, back into the arrow zone. And here is Oleg Shargorodsky. Gallops back in behind the twine. And up the right wing boards he will come. Shargorodsky. Long pass, center ice for Young. Tip the puck back into the San Diego zone. Back for it is Mark DeSantis. He rolled it into the corner. Tip it in there to have a look at it. Tippett battling in there with Mike Maniluk. Big battle for the puck, and it comes to the near side, and it's picked up by Maniluk. He'll get it out to center ice. Harassed by St. Cyr, but Maniluk there to dump it into the arrow zone. Here is Steve Jakes now. In behind his net, he'll roll the puck along the boards, but it's picked up by Maniluk. And right now, to be quite honest with you, Russ, right now the San Diego Gulls look like they're on fire here, and the Arrows having a little trouble getting anything offensively generated.
Arrows came out a little bit sluggish. Hopefully that goal by the Gulls will pick him up.
Here is Shargorodsky now. He'll get it to the line. Ruchin trying to hold it in, and he did. Right side, gently rolls it down. Here's a chance. Maniluk cuts down, centered it, and hit Jakes. Now the puck comes out far side. Ruchin again, circles away from Shargorodsky. Oleg's got him wrapped up to positive, but he shakes off the check, comes back to the circle. Now again, he's worked on by Easy. Centered the pass, and that was tipped away by Jakes. Right now it's all San Diego, and here's a penalty coming up to Jakes. 3 minutes gone by in the second. Jakes talking with Maniluk, and when we return, we'll bring you the San Diego power play. But hold on here. We've got Jakes and Maniluk talking, and we've got DeSantis and St. Cyr looking at each other. And the linesman getting in there.
Arrows would love it if they could get a goal or two to go out with them. Jakes is getting the initial 2 minutes. It may be a cross-check on Jakes, but he's definitely getting the initial two. And the Arrows may well be shorthanded here. They're in a little danger of having this thing get away from them. The second period has belonged to San Diego so far. It's 1-0, and I believe there'll be a power play coming for the goal.
We'll sort it out for you when we return. 3 minutes gone by in the second. 1-0 San Diego. We're back after this.
This label tells you it's 100% cotton. This label tells you it's 100% real cheese. And this label tells you it's 100% low fares. Always check the label. Southwest, the low fare airline. Southwest Airlines wrote the book on low fares. And it's available in paperback. For low fares to more places more often, fly Southwest, the low fare airline.
Face-off will be brought to center ice, and right now 2 minutes up on the board to Jakes, and that seems to be really the only penalty out of all that. Well, they'll face it off at center ice.
They got everybody quieted down. But Jakes is out, cross-checking the call. Kind of a weak call there in the cross-check. He got both hands on the stick and up a little bit, but it wasn't a vicious cross-check by any stretch.
Head coach Walt Kyle screaming at the referee. Talk about a competitor there.
A very competitive guy on and off the ice. Here's a guy who's gone through cancer problems twice. Bone cancer and stomach cancer. He has just really been fighting the real battle, the ultimate battle, and hanging in there and keeps coaching, keeps plugging away, and he's a guy you really kind of have to tip your hat to.
Kind of makes hockey secondary, you know.
It really does.
Here is Mark Freer. He'll face off at center ice against Mark Beaufay, who gets credited with that San Diego goal. And it's 1-0. The goals lead it, and they're back on the power play. Let's see how the Arrows handle this. It's the puck back in their own end. Donatelli flipped it to the near side. Picked up by Beaufay. Base of the left circle getting set. Drifts back. Left wing down to the base of the circle now. It's controlled back for Beaufay. Walks in. Centered. Here's Lilly the drive. Blocked by Dobson. Rebound. Tipped in there. Dobson another save, and he's down and covering up. He got a pad on it. Now Foy getting sticks high with Mark Donatelli. Play halted with 16:41 to go in the second. 1-0 San Diego.
He made one great save. He shouldn't have had to make the second great save. Arrows should have covered up a little bit better, and they did not. Scott Arneal had an opportunity in there to cover up in the slot, keep some people away from Dobson. Arneal didn't quite make the play coming down in the slot. Beaufay got a good opportunity. Dobson will make the first save. You can't make him have to make the second save.
Face off to the left of Dobson now. Freer to take the draw against Beaufay, and he wins the draw. Beaufay does. Back to the right side now. Here is Van Imp. Rolled it down the left side, but Van Imp got it back to the right side. Top of the slot. Turner wide. Shoots. Whistle wide. Rebound. Jumped on Donatelli, but he couldn't redirect it into the net. Now the puck in behind. Here's John Lilly. Rolls it to Beaufay. Base to the left circle. Now to a left point. Turner fakes now. Lets the shot go. Deflected wide of the net. I think Foy got a stick on it for the Arrows. Here's Van Imp. Walked around. Freer's check. Now has it down low. Donatelli. Top of the slot. Turner fakes the shot. Beaufay shoots. Hit the side of the net. Didn't get good wood on it, and he just tripped it wide of the net. And there's Scott Arneal to backhand it down the ice. 1:02 remaining in the penalty to Jakes. 4 minutes gone by in the second, and a 1-0 goal lead.
Watching Donatelli out there, it's interesting. I remember when he used to be one of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Oh, man. Here is Mark Ferner. He'll shoot the puck into the Arrow zone.
See, that's Donatello.
Oh, man.
You obviously don't keep up with the little green guys.
No, not much. Here's the puck picked up now by Loach. Right wing board. He gets set. Loach down the left side for McDonough. Now Ferner top of the slot for Loach. Top of the right circle. Here's McDonough. Loach lets the shot go. That hit Dobson. Rebound. Sackle couldn't get it in there. And now back to the slot. Ferner for McDonough. Now Loach and the Gulls really sharp with their passing as they center it. And Dobson had the presence of mind to see that one and cover it up with 15:20 to play in the second. 1-0 San Diego, 16 seconds left in the penalty.
Adam, we talked about it before that in the earlier San Diego power plays, the Arrows were forcing them to take shots from well out. Dobson was seeing it. It's obvious that what they've decided to do in the power play opportunity now is not settle for those shots from high in the slot or from the point. They're bringing it down on the corners. They're coming out from the corners and getting shots from pretty close in on Rob Dobson. So an obvious change in strategy in the power play for San Diego.
Yeah, the Arrows normally use more of a passive forecheck on the penalty killing, but this time they're very active on it. As you see, Eve, top of the slot watching Ferner, but Loach walks in, lets a drive go right on, and that will sail right into Dobson, and he will hold on with 15:12 to play in the second and 8 seconds left into Jakes Minor in the goal for the 1-0 lead.
Well, we've talked talked about the Arrows' problem the last couple of games in playing with the lead, maintaining a lead. They've had no problem this year playing from behind. They did that in the very opening game of the season at Denver. They played well from behind. They were down in the home opener, came back from behind, tied it up, won it in the shootout. So playing behind, from behind has not bothered them.
Face off to the left of Rob Dobson. Again, 8 seconds left to Jakes, and the Gulls win the draw. Here is Ferner, left point. That's the shot. That hit on the key. Here's another try to spank off Dobson. Now over is Jakes out of the box, and the Arrows once again get the job done.
It was a good power play by San Diego, though.
Here is Hubie McDonough now. Jumps on the loose puck, blocked through McKee. Kind of a weak effort on the check there. He tried to put the shoulder into him, and McDonough went right around him. Kind of like 6'10 does to Houston. Now the puck dumped into the Arrows zone, and here is Curtis Hunt now up the left side. He'll launch the puck to center and tip it. Trying to find the handle. St. Cyr there to sweep it into San Diego territory. 14:33 to play in the second. 1-0 San Diego. Here's a pass. Center ice for Hubie McDonough. Dropped it ahead for the breaking Craig Reichert. He lets the shot go. That's redirected. And now it is Eve by Reichert. And there was Craig Reichert to push it ahead. Now St. Cyr in his own zone. Give it to Brian McKee. And the Gulls are offside. With 14:16 left in the second. 1-0 San Diego. We're back right after this.
Where the flavor of Mexico sizzles.
Mark Freer to take the draw against Steve Ruchin here.
You know, if you told me back in the 70s that in 1994, 7 or 10 or 15,000 people would be singing YMCA by the Village People in unison, I'd have told you you were crazy, but that's what was going on here during the break.
Marshall back to touch it up and hold on. Now, I'm wondering if people are going to start singing other health clubs, you know, like World's Gyms. You know, I mean, is that going to happen?
All I can tell you is when these fans of the Arrows start dressing like the Village People, that's when I cancel the show and go home.
Looking at the shots on goal in the second period, the Arrows, well, yet without a shot on goal, San Diego, 7 of them.
Yeah, well, I mean, we said earlier, it's no really surprise. We said San Diego came out, took charge from the opening faceoff here in the second period, and the shots on goal tell the story. They got one by Dobson and the wraparound by Beaufait, and it's 1-0.
Off the draw now, here is Jason Marshall tapping down the left side for Ruchin. Now Matalak turns base to the right circle in the Arrow zone. Here's a chance. Matalak shakes off the check. He fell, though, coughed up the puck, and off to the races goes Freer. Down the left side of Larnie. Center that pass and Bester there, and oh my, oh, Craig Reichert put a big elbow into Brian Pellerin, and Pellerin is down right now. I'm sure he'll pop up shortly, but boy, he's gonna get a penalty here.
Yeah, Reichert's going out. That's the key thing. That's the key thing. Pellerin took one for the team. A little 3-on-2 break, and Pellerin was in the middle, and the play was really over as Pellerin skated out in front and was heading towards the goaltender. The play really had died on the centering pass that just kind of trickled to the goaltender, and Bester covered it up. Then the big elbow sent Pellerin sprawling. What they call it might be a hook.
How the heck do they not give him a game for that? If that's not intent, you got to tell me what is, Ross.
Yeah, I don't know. They call it the hook. And that certainly looked like an intentional situation there. But, hey, they sent him out for two. Pellerin takes one for the team. And the Arrows, who have not had a shot on goal yet in this period, get a power play opportunity. That's the good news. Bad news is the power play tonight is an over, and they have not been doing well in the power play this year.
Here is Freer, Arneal, and Townsend with McKee and Shargorodsky. Drop of the puck. Here's McKee, top of the slot, trying to find Freer. It'll go down for Scott Arneal. Back to the slot. Here is McKee, a shot that's redirected. Maybe a shot he should have waited on, but instead he let it go, and the Gulls are there to dump it down the ice. Here's Oleg Shargorodsky now. He'll sail in behind his net, and he'll start the rush from left to right. Arrows need to get it going here. They trail by a score of 1-0. And a
minute 36 left on the power play. Shargorodsky moving around Beaufay. He'll hit the line, and his pass was intercepted, but Townsend got it back. Now Graham Townsend for Mark Freer. Gets the eye on the Ferner check. Freer, base of the left circle, cough the puck up. It's picked up by Beaufay. Cleared to the line, not out. Shargorodsky, nice job of holding it in. Now to Scott Arneil. He'll turn left side. Worked it down. They get the right wing for Freer. In behind the net. He's got Townsend in front, but he gives Arneil base of the right circle. Now, top of the slot. McKee lets the shot go. That hit Freer and deflected into the near corner. A minute four on the power play. 1-0 San Diego. It is Arneil. Rolled it for Freer. Right wing boards. Cuts in. Shoots. That was redirected wide. Now Arneil cuts in. Centered it. That may have hit the side of the net. And the goals are there to shoot it down the ice with 12 and a half to play in the second. 1-0 San Diego. Under a minute to go on the power play. Now the Arrows have caught the goals in a line change. Here's Tippett shooting. Bester the save. The rebound. As Cinneroni trying to jam one in there. And Bester makes a fine save. Let's take a timeout. 1-0 San Diego. We're back after this.
Attention, school is now in session. Watch Texas high school football's brightest stars shine coast to coast, zone to zone. The Alamo High School Extra, Sunday mornings at 9 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. on HSE.
It's the most exciting game plan in town. If you're a fantasy football player or just love the sport, be sure to catch Playoff Fantasy Football Weekly with veteran analyst Norm Hitzkus and Pro Football Weekly's Rick Korch.
Thursdays at 11 on HSE.
With a quick shot, and Bester got a piece of that, and now it is Clayton Young, base of the right circle, trying to tip it in behind, but Marshall is there. He'll roll it up the circle. He's hit by Chris Foy. Here is Dave Tippett now as the Arrows trying to pick up the intensity a little bit, down by a goal. Here is Clayton Young in behind the San Diego net, centered it. It came out in front, but the Gulls are there to work it down. The Arrows doing a fine job working along the wall, but couldn't get a good scoring opportunity.
I think the word you used is the right one, intensity. They have clearly picked that up, and it's given them a couple of good chances, that and the fact that they have a man advantage.
Power play is now over, and teams are at five aside. Reichert back out on the pond, and here is Tippett, crosses the line, dropped it for Cinneroni. He's creamed by Donatelli, and then Cinneroni run into by Donatelli again, and those two look at each other. Donatelli got stick side. I think we're going to get a delayed penalty on Donatelli here.
Well, if that's the case, now that the call is made, and you're right, it's a high stick on Donatelli. Cinneroni thought about it. He thought about it. He looked Donatelli square in the eye and thinks about maybe it's time to rough it up a little bit here. But he thinks better of it because Donatelli's going out for 2 minutes, and Mario Cinneroni knows that in spite of this high stick and a pretty cheap shot thrown by Donatelli, Mario's team is about to get a power play. So he thinks better of it. They stare each other down a little bit, and Cinneroni decides, I'll take the power play, and maybe we'll get into it a little bit later on.
I'll tell you what, the Arrows are now 0-3. How important is it to get a power play goal here? You got to understand that if you don't score on the power play, teams are going to take liberties like that all night, because they'll say, fine, we'll go down a man because you can't score.
No, that's true. I think people won't be afraid to put you in a power play. Conversely, the best teams in the league on the power play scare the heck out of other teams that know any kind of cheap penalty could cost them a goal.
Faceoff will be to the right of Alan Bester. Freer, St. Cyr. Out there along with Mike Yeo. Top of the puck. And it's controlled by Ferner of the Gulls. Can he clear it? He'll get it to the line and out to center ice. But there is Brian McKee now. He'll lob the puck ahead. St. Cyr has to regroup at center. Long lead pass to the left side for Shargorodsky now. He'll flip it in behind the San Diego net. Bester out of there, but it's given away. Here's the snapshot off the post. Oh, my. The Arrows had a chance, and it clanked it off the iron. It'll go down the ice. Well, if those don't fall, I don't know what will.
You just got to keep shooting them. Keep shooting them, and eventually some will go in.
This kind of is the same scenario I think we saw against Atlanta last Friday. Here is a pass for St. Cyr as he crosses the line. Bester comes out to clear it. Now McKee at center. He'll lob one for Oleg Shargorodsky. Down the left side, he'll blast it into San Diego territory. Picked away by St. Cyr, right side. Trying to find Eves. Here is Yeo. He's run off the puck. Van Imp takes over for San Diego. He's muscled by St. Cyr, but he gets the puck down the ice with 10.5 to play in the second. And a 1-0 San Diego lead. The Arrows have 60 seconds left on the power play. Now it is Mark Freer circling at center ice up the left side for Arneil. Cross the line with Townsend. He centered it. Townsend couldn't get lumber on it. Now McKee, right point. He's muscled off the puck, but Freer's got it as he cuts in. Freer shoots. Bester to save the rebound. And it's covered up by Bester, and he'll hold on. 10-12 to play in the second. 1-0 San Diego. We're back after this.
Sam Houston Race Park. Wednesday, October 12th, the season begins. The thoroughbreds are back. More thrills, more winnings, more power. Wednesday, October 12th, the incredible thoroughbred season returns at Sam Houston Race Park. Find out why they call it horsepower.
Have 44 seconds on the power play, but Russ, they were close.
They're going to have to beat Bester. He's not going to give him a gift. He can play hot and cold, and tonight he's hot.
Here is Scott Arneal, right wing boards. He'll get set on the power play. Shoots that hit Marshall. Now Arneal trying to catch up to the puck, but it comes to center. Here's a chance for the shorthanded goals. John Lilly crosses the line, moves to his right. He's in no hurry. He'll just shoot it back to his own blue line and kill off some time. And there's Van Empe to shoot it down. Is Chris Foy at his own blue line. Lead pass for Arneal, tipped off his stick, and there's Van Imp. He'll roll it back into toward the Arrows blue line. Here's a pass now up the left side for Arneal as he hits the line. Rink wide pass, fair line, centered the shot, they score! Fantastic! They worked that to perfection. Arrows tie the game at one. It's a power play goal!
Equalizer here, and we're tied at one apiece. But you can't say enough, Adam, about that pass made out in front by Freer to set up Townsend for the easy one.
He feathered a beauty, and Graham notches his second goal of the year, and we're tied at one. Freer will get an assist, and I think Arneal will get the other. Puck shot back into the Arrow zone. Curtis Hunt will hustle back, and he'll pick up the puck in the left side. But he'll move it up the left side. Looking for Pellerin. It goes into San Diego territory for Chartier. Banks it off the wall. Manilok gets it out to center ice and a monumental goal for the Arrows to get back and tie this hockey game up. 9:03 to play in the second. We're tied at one. Riker, he's wrapped up and now it is Jakes. His pass taken by Clayton Young. He'll cross the line with Tippett. Young down the right side. Moving in, but he was pushed by DeSantis. Now into the corners. DeSantis in a skate-to-skate battle with Clayton Young. Right wing boards. Young fights him off with a good body check, but now out to center ice, back into Arrow territory, Shargorodsky back, and we're going to get a penalty. 8:40 left, and I think we're going to get a penalty here, and we'll take a timeout, sort it out when we return. 1-1 our score. We're back after this.
The name of the game is speed. Flying on steel blades across an arena of ice, stopping on a dime. Houston has a new way of flying. They're called the Arrows, and they're Houston's newest pro team. They'll be earning their wings every day. Bringing you thrills and chills will be their goal.
Sunday on HSE.
Clayton Young in the box with 8:40 left in this second period, tied at one. He's in the box for roughing. The Arrows will be shorthanded once again.
They've been pretty good shorthanded, and the last time they were pretty good on the power play. So they need to maintain this 1-1 tie here. So far, so good.
Here's Ferner back to center. He'll roll it over to Loach, who jams the puck back into Houston territory. Dobson knocked it down. Here is Cittaroni. He'll get it out to the line and out to center ice for a breaking bird.
Slide the puck to him. but he got behind Bester and backhanded it in cleanly for a shorthanded goal and a 2-1 lead. Here they come again.
Here's a shot by Freer, and that's knocked down by Ferner. And this loud crowd on top of this one as the Arrows have their first lead of the night, and now it is Lynch to center. It'll go into the zone. A quick shot ripped wide of the net. Now the puck back to left point. McDonough looking for Lonnie Loach. It comes to Sacco. Sacco to Loach. Right wing board. He'll set up the power play. Yes, the goal's still on the man advantage. Ferner top of the slot. Shoots. That's deflected high and wide. Puck to the near corner. It's picked up by Sacco. He'll get it to the line. Not out. Held in by Ferner. He'll center it. That's redirected line. Al McDonough in behind the cage. He'll give it up to the far point. Left. Right point. Ferner. It's launched down low. McDonough looking for Loach. Back for Ferner. Gets set. Makes the shot. Dances back. Top of the slot. Now Loach. Rolls it for McDonough. Trying to center. That's knocked away by Foy. He can't clear though. Here is Loach again. Wine. Shoots. Good save. Dobson. He'll hold on. A big blast by Lonnie Loach. And there was Dobson. Let's take a break. 7:10 left in the second. 2-1 Arrows. We're back after this.
This October? Well, check out HSE's October lineup. The Arrows and Stars pull out the blades to carve up the ice.
Schumann.
The Southland SWC, SEC, and Pac-10 look to throw some treats and hand out some tricks. And the women of the SWC are bringing out the spice.
Yikes.
Still looking for some thrills? Well, tune in to HSE in October.
Zone. Power play still on for the goals. 15 left to Young's minor for roughing. Here is Beaufay. He'll get it down. Lilly centered the pass. It's in front. And there was Eves to clear it, but not out. Ferner fakes the shot. He got Tippett to go down. Now a chance is it's knocked away by Shargorodsky. He couldn't clear it. Here's Shargorodsky again. Left corner. Get it back to the line. It's down to center ice. The penalty over as Young back out on the ice. Here is Ferner right side. He'll get it ahead, but got it back. Ferner over the line. Takes a shoulder from Shargorodsky. And oh my, they're going to call him for a penalty as he stuck that knee out. And now Ferner wants it. Shargorodsky. Oleg knew that Ferner had gone around him and looked like he got the knee out there pretty good.
Well, he went to give him a good clean check. He never intended to trip him or knee him or do anything like that. But as he stepped by him and he realized he'd been beaten, he got that leg out just a little bit, and that's going to send him off for a penalty here. And so the Arrows, who just finished killing off a penalty situation, are going to have to do it again. Early in this period, San Diego came out strong, scored to take a 1-0 lead, and had the first 7 shots on goal in this period. Since then, the shots on goal tally is 6-1 in favor of the Arrows, and they've scored twice. Kneeing is the call on Oleg Shagoronsky. You just can't do that. He realized he got beaten. He got the big knee up there, and really they kind of almost lock knees. It can be dangerous at times, but he got the knee right up there, and you're not allowed to do that.
You know, one of the keys was the specialty teams for the Arrows coming to. We talked more about the power play, but generally speaking, the specialty teams had to be the one, and you look at the 2 Arrow goals. One's a power play tally. The other's a shorthanded goal.
Well, they're on special teams again. They're down 1, but they're up 1 on the big scoreboard. Arrows 2 and Gulls 1.
You know, you look at the Arrows, their lowest total has been 23 this year in shots on goal. Already they have 20, and we're at 6:23 left of the second period. Puck back in the goal zone, and yes, they're on the power play, and from right to left they'll come. Young and Chitteroni doing the job for the Arrows, killing off the first part of this power play for the San Diego Gulls, and Young able to backhand it back into the San Diego zone, and here's Chitteroni on his horse. Can he get there? No, he can't. Sacco able to clear it up to center.
And the value of the shorthanded goal a moment ago makes San Diego think about that and look behind him a little bit.
Here's Darren Van Itt now, glancing down the right side. He'll set up. Pretty good defenseman. Likes to pinch, though. And he's doing that right now on the right side. Van Imp trying to circle it back. He'll chop it down. Here's a chance. McDonough centered it, but it's picked away by Chitteroni, and he'll come to center ice. Mario Chitteroni right side, and he'll just calmly roll it back into San Diego territory. 5:40 to go in the second. Arrows lead at 2-1. A minute 10 left to Shargorodsky. Here is Loach. He'll get it to McDonough. No, it eluded him. Valamont is back, shouldered by McDonough. And Valamont in a pretty good battle. He just fell on top of the puck, and he turtles on top of it, and then he was able to get rid of that thing. He'll eject it back to the point. Here's a chance now as the goal's moving in. A centering pass. That's tipped away. Nice play. McDonough tried to move it in, as did Sacco, but that goes down the ice, and now a chance. Freer on his horse. Bester came out. Freer takes it away. He took it in front, looks in front, sent it, and Bester worked out of the way. Mark Freer did a fine job. Now a chance for Lilly, base in the right circle for Beaufay. He'll get it back to the point for Ferner. Looks for the shot. Here's the drive by Marshall. That hit Freer, and the arrows come away. Scott Arneal short-handed. He'll move it down the left side, trying to get around Ferner. It's dropped back. Arneal's got it, though. Arneal lobbed it for Freer in behind the net. Arrows doing a good job. Here's a penalty to Marshall as he gave Freer a pretty good ride on the end wall. And that'll do it for the San Diego power play, which had only 10 seconds remaining. The Arrows are going to be on the power play with 4:37 left in the second period. Arrows lead it 2-1. And when we return, we'll bring you the Arrows power play. We're back after this.
The Best Team Outdoors features the best block of outdoor programming in the Southwest. A group of the finest sportsmen ever assembled to help you catch more fish, have better hunts, and enjoy the great outdoors. True sportsmen practice catch and release, conservation, and preservation of nature. But they bring something home as well. A great time.
Seven left in the second period. Arrows lead it 2-1. Russ, a pretty vicious cross check here.
Jason Marshall with the cross check on Freer. Coming right at the boards the way it did. If the cross check hurt, and getting slammed into the boards hurt too. Freer's all right. And the Arrows will go on a power play. They lead by the score of 2-1. It's actually 10 seconds left on the penalty to Oleg Sharkarodsky. So in 10 seconds, it'll be a man advantage for the Arrows. They'll be 4-on-4 here for just a little bit. It would behoove them to control the puck, keep it in the zone when their extra skater comes out and joins them.
Face off in the circle to the right side of Alan Bester. Sticks down as Eves to take the draw against Mark Beaufay, but they're both going to be tossed. So now Lilly against Clayton Young. Lilly played for the Seattle Thunderbirds 2 years ago, and his head coach, Walt Kyle, the head coach of the San Diego Gulls. Here's a puck now, back at the left point. Arrows have got it. McKee, a weak pass, and that comes back to center ice and towards his own zone, and he gave the puck away again. Beaufay now up for Ferner, and now the Arrows are on the power play. Sharkarodsky back out on the ice.
See, but what happened there is San Diego had the puck when the Arrows got the power play. That's going to cost him about 20 seconds.
Now it is Eves. He'll race up ice into the blue line and into the San Diego zone. Dropped it. McKee lets his shot go. That was a weak one that was deflected. Now Ferner blasted along the wall, and the Gulls able to shovel it back to center ice. A minute 28 left in the Marshall Minor, and 4 minutes to play in the second. 2-1 our score here from the Summit in Houston. Now, here's Dave Tippett, right side. Tippett cuts center. The pass.
They just lost sight of Young. I think they're thinking Tippett's going to try to slide the puck to Murray Eves. And Young slides in there. And Young now in his last four games, 4 goals and a couple of assists for 6 points. And a big goal here. The way these one-goal games have gone, Adam, having a two-goal lead is like having a laugher here. The Arrows lead 3-1, 3:54 to play in the second period.
Well, we talked about the Arrows and they're playing with a lead, so now we'll see how that key comes to effect now. The Arrows have built a two-blot lead at 3-1, and they'll shoot the puck back into the San Diego zone. And another power play goal, so 2 power play goals and a short added tally for the Arrows. Here's a drive by Hunt, that's deflected in. The Gulls come away with a 3-on-2. Here is Nanaluk, stop, shoots, and he ripped it wide of the net. Bounces back to the right wing board, the puck centered again. Nanaluk cuts in behind the net, looks, he centered that pass. That's worked away by Jakes. Now Ruchin was hooked down by St. Cyr. Then St. Cyr gives a shot to Nanaluk, and we're going to get St. Cyr with a penalty here with 3:21 left in the second period. The Arrows are going to be shorthanded once again. And all of a sudden now, you kind of wonder about the Arrow penalty killing, how much they can do. But we'll worry about that when we return. 3-1, the Arrows lead it. We're back after this.
We'll be right back. HSE. It's music to your eyes.
Zooming it up on the board to Jerry St. Cyr for hooking. It'll be Breer against McDonough in the circle to the right side of Robbie Dobson. And the Gulls win the draw. Here is Sacco. He'll get it over to a right point, but it's tipped down now. Loach, right point, Ferner. He'll set the power play up. Here is Sacco getting set on the left side, top of the slot for Ferner. Now Loach, he's got a bullet. Likes to let that howitzer fly, but instead gives it to McDonough. Centered, score! It was jammed in there by Brian Sullivan. And it took all of 19 seconds on the power play, and the goal's back on the board, and it's 3-2 Houston.
Well, it has seemed that this entire period has been played with somebody on the power play. And indeed, the last four goals in this period, three have been power play goals, and one has been shorthanded. Sullivan gets set up in front, and he's just all alone for a little forehander as the centering pass comes. They just lost sight of Sullivan. It was a good pass out in front, and he just put it home. Pretty easy pickings for Sullivan at that moment. And we're now in a 3-2 game on the goal by Brian Sullivan.
For Brian Sullivan, it's his third goal of the year, a power play goal, and it's 3-2 now in favor of Houston. And there's 2:55 left, and here is Oleg Shargorodsky now as he sails in behind his net to the shoulder from Sullivan. And the Arrows can't move it out of there. It's picked up by Loach. Loach circles right wing boards, cuts down the middle now to the slot. Give it to DeSantis. Looks for the shot. That's blocked by Young. Get it to the line, not out. Loach held it in. Now Townsend, he tries to clear. McDonough's there to take over. Arrows had built a two-goal lead, but it didn't take San Diego long to come back within one as the puck goes out of play with 2.5 to play here in period two, 3-2 in favor of Houston. Next telecast for the Houston Arrows. You can catch it this Sunday against the Atlanta Knights. It all begins Sunday afternoon at 4 o'clock. Be sure to join Russ Small and myself. We'll have pregame festivities beginning at 4 o'clock and the faceoff at 4:08.
3-2, the Arrows lead. It was a scoreless first period. In this period, Beaufay opened the scoring within the first minute of play. And then it was three successive goals by the Arrows before San Diego scored again, and so it's 3-2.
Here's Darren Van Imp for San Diego. Lobs the puck into the Houston zone. Shargorodsky trying to clear it, and he got it to the line, and now Mike Yeo to center ice for Graham Townsend. He starts up ice for the speeding Clayton Young. Right side, cuts into the backhander, missed it badly to the short side. Now Lilly, he'll get it to the line, and it meanders out to center ice. 2:04 left in the second. Arrows with a one-goal lead at 3-2. Puck resting in the San Diego zone. Young shouldered in there now by Jason Marshall. Yeo trying to dig it out. It comes back to Young. Quick shot snapped and blocked. Now Townsend trying to advance it. Here's a chance. Yeo pulls up. Quick shot. Blocker saved by Bester. Gave up a rebound, and there was Bester. Who got a little cute. Got that blocker on it. Now we've got Graham Townsend all locked up with one of the goals. And they're in a wrestling match between the circles right in front of Alan Bester. 1:47 left in the second period. The Arrows on top 3-2, but I haven't seen the sweater number of who the goal is that's down there. And trying to find out who that is.
That's good. If you can see his sweater number, that means he's on top. If it's the other guys, you want him on the bottom. We could see Graham Townsend's number. That meant he was on top. And that's the way we like it. The Arrows lead here by the score of 3-2. They've had some good opportunities. Alan Bester's made some good saves. Covers up well when the Arrows try to get in on him, as Townsend did a moment ago to start that little skirmish with Marshall. But it is 3-2. Beaufay opened the scoring in the period, made it 1-0 San Diego. Then it was Townsend on a power play. Murray Eaves shorthanded, and Clayton Young, his fourth of the year, on a power play for a 3-1 lead. But then it was Sullivan, his third of the year, on a power play, coming just 53 seconds after the Young score to make it 3-2. And that's where we stand with 1:47 remaining in this period.
Faceoff will be in the circle to the left side of Alan Bester, and Murray Eaves will take the draw, and he's going to be your second period guest.
And a big shorthanded goal for Murray tonight, his first of the year. I don't care what level you're at, where you're at, getting that first one is big. Once you get the first one, you get that out of the way, you can relax a little bit when you got the puck in the zone and an opportunity to score. So he finally got his first shorthanded, and off we go from here.
Well, he may have to come up again here as... Are the Arrows going to have a power play here? They got everything all messed up.
Looks
I've got
like
four Arrows.
4-4.
The score clock was throwing me off. That's what I thought. Should have been even strength.
I'm sure he sent Marshall and Townsend both out.
Faceoff will be to the left of Alan Bester. McDonough against Eves. 3-2 in favor of the Houston Aeros. And co-captain Murray Eves barking instructions to Brian McKee where he wants him to line up for the faceoff. Eves against McDonough. Sticks down, drop of the puck, and Eves wins it. Now a chance for Foy at a right point. Lobs the puck down for Eves in behind the San Diego net. He's wrapped up in there by Ferner. Now in there. He goes. Roach. Ooh, shoveled one off the side of his own net. And Bester says they better hold on to that one. 1:33 left in the second. 3-2 Aeros. A minute 46 left in the coincidental minors to both Townsend and Marshall.
Dave Tippett there watching that puck just a moment ago, bouncing off the back of the net. He saw that puck tree. His eyes got real wide. He knows he's standing there just outside the crease, and there's a loose puck there somewhere. And David wanted to pounce on it right away and try to put one home and help this team.
Off the faceoff. Aeros win another one, but they tripped it out to center ice. And Chris Foy goes back to his own blue line. Snap pass ahead for McKee. He'll roll one back for Foy. A bad pass. Here's McDonough now. Has got it now. Right wing boards. Nice pass. Brought in. Here's the drive. Dobson the save. That was ripped by Barry Drager. Now up the left wing. It is Murray Eves from Tippett. Eves crosses the line. Here is Eves. Nice drop. Pass just eluding Chris Foy. Nice play. Just a little ahead of him there. And the Gulls will turn it around with a minute to play in the second period. And the Aeros lead it 3-2. Loach trying to bounce one ahead. Here's a chance for Ferner. Left wing. In behind the Aero net. Ferner comes out, center the pass. Dobson with a nice save as he butterflies with a left pad and got that out of there, and the rebound is cleared. Now Loach, shouldered in there by Foy, wins the battle, centered the puck, back to the line. The drive by Van Imp, and that's grazed off the crossbar and out of play with 36 seconds remaining in the second period. Aeros lead it 3-2, but some good scoring opportunities late in this period by the Gulls.
Doubled by the Gulls. Moments ago, though, in the other end. A nice soft drop pass from Murray Eves to Chris Foy. You could see that from up here developing, that he had the trailer coming to give him a 3-on-2. And you said it was just a little too far for Foy to reach. Well, it was, but only a little bit. Foy's got to come up with that. It was a nice soft drop pass, and he's got to come up with it and keep the pressure on. He did not, and the puck went to the other end where the Gulls had some opportunities.
Off the draw now. We're half a minute remaining in this second period, and another chance now. Beaufay trying to cut around Shargorodsky, and Oleg imprints him along the far wall. And it's picked up by Freer. Here's Mark Freer now. Right wing boards, cross-ice pass, batted down by Beaufay, but it comes to Shargorodsky. Oleg in a battle along the far boards with 10 seconds left in the period. Now the puck brought in by Chartier. His drive trickles into the corner. Picked up by Freer. He's muscled by Lilly. And 1 second left in the period, and that will do it as this second period comes to an end. And a very free-spirited period for the Houston Aeros, who went down 1-0 in that period from a Beaufay goal. Not the prettiest of goals, but one that Beaufay will take. But the Aeros showed their composure, coming back with 3 unanswered goals to take a 3-1 lead, only to have the Gulls strike back on the Brian Sullivan tally. And that's how we find ourselves after 2 periods of play. Our score, it's the Houston Aeros 3 and the San Diego Gulls 2. And when we return, Russ Small will chat with Murray Eves. That's up next on the Aeros Broadcasting Network.
There's a champion for you.
Raymond Floyd, winner of 31 PGA Tour events.
Hi, I'm Raymond Floyd. I'm hitting the ball farther now than in any time in my career, and I'm convinced it's because of the flexibility and strength routine I started 10 years ago. I believe you too can benefit from a program specially designed to exercise the muscles important to the golf swing. Fit for Golf exercises will increase your flexibility and strength and improve your ability as a golfer to play longer and stronger each day. It's an easy workout program for all ages designed to increase both flexibility and strength. Fit for Golf is a great gift for a spouse, parent, or professional associate, and it costs less than the price of a dozen good golf balls.
To order your video, call 1-800-327-9994 or send $19.95 plus $4.95 for shipping and handling to the address on your screen.
It's time to jam.
dig it?
It's time to jam with college football all season on HSE.
Can you dig it?
It's time to jam.
Can you dig it?
All right, we're number one.
No way, we're number one.
You guys stink.
Better than you.
We'll see about that.
Arizona battles Washington State live Saturday at 5:30 on HSE.
It's time to jam.
Can you dig it?
Vandy is looking to stop Georgia as the Dogs are whooping with Zaire in an SEC battle between the hedges. Vanderbilt battles Georgia live Saturday at 11:30 on HSE.
It's 3-2 here in the second period intermission. Adam Gordon along with Russ Small, and a very entertaining second period of play. The Arrows had fallen behind on an early goal in that second period by Beaufay. But three unanswered goals put the Arrows up by a score of 3-1. And then the goals got that Brian Sullivan power play tally. And that's how we find ourselves after a couple periods of play. In fact, only one even strength goal in that whole period. It was Beaufay who got it. And then the Arrows came back with a power play goal from Townsend, a shorthanded goal from Eaves, a power play goal from Young, and then that power play goal from Sullivan. And with that shorthanded goal, Murray Eaves, he's standing by with our Russ Small. Russ?
Adam, thank you very much. 3-2 is the score here in the second intermission. Murray Eaves, how about that second period? We go scoreless in the first, and all of a sudden everybody's scoring there in the second period.
Yeah, we definitely need to win here, and the only way you're going to do that is to have more goals than the other team. And fortunately, we got a couple power play goals, a shorthanded goal, but let them score a late goal. They scored an early goal, but there's still 20 minutes to play, and it's going to be a dogfight to the end.
Specialty teams played real well in that period with a couple of power play goals and the shorthanded goal. Talk to us a bit here about your shorthanded goal and watch it as you do.
Well, I got the pass from Mario here and pulled it to the backhand, waited, just got a piece of it, and it kind of rolled over a friend of mine, Alan Bester, the goalie in the opposing net tonight, but it was a good play by Mario to get it up to me.
Yeah, the key play obviously made at center ice when Cittaroni sees you, makes the nice soft pass, keeps it onside, gets you away free. Now, we thought at the end you held it. I thought for a second there maybe you'd held it too long.
Well, I got hooked there by the defenseman from the San Diego team, and luckily I finally broke that egg, got a goal, and it definitely helps my confidence, and hopefully it can be a contributor to a victory tonight.
You're a guy who's had several 30 and 40 goal seasons in your career. You expect to score some goals here for the Arrows.
Well, Pete Dineen brought me here for that reason, to score some goals, but to also add some experience to help the younger kids. And, hopefully I want to contribute to the team in the goal department, but anything else I can do for the success of this team, I'm going to do it.
Did your buddy Alan Bester say anything to you after you beat him?
Yeah, he said it was a nice goal. Actually, I wanted to go five hole, which between the legs, but I decided to take it to the old trusty backhand, and fortunately it rolled in.
But hope he gets a chance to pat you on the back one or two more times in the third period with nice goal. That'd be sweet.
Thank you very much. Yeah, sure would.
That's Murray Eaves. It is 3-2. The Arrows lead the San Diego Gulls after a couple of periods here at the Summit. I'm Russ Small. Adam and I will be back right after this.
When you watch the Weather Channel, you get the most accurate and convenient weather forecast available. But weather changes, and those changes do affect your plans. So add cable and the Weather Channel to every one of your TV sets. Get tomorrow's forecast just before you go to sleep. Check it before you leave in the morning, or keep it handy throughout the day. Clearly, additional cable hookups add convenience to your life. Get the Weather Channel anytime. Call your cable operator today and add cable to every TV.
Hi, I'm Larry Forehand. At Casa Olay, you'll taste the delicious difference in our food from the very first bite. Everything at Casa Olay is prepared fresh at each location. Try our tasty chili con queso made with 100% real American cheese, beans and rice prepared fresh daily, and what can I say about our crisp chips and hot sauces? You guessed it, made fresh every day. Now that's a fabulous start to a great meal. So the next time you crave great Mexican food, taste the difference. Casa Olay, fresh today.
Prestigious and unpredictable courses.
Witness the memories and magic of the European PGA.
The Alfred Dunhill Cup, Friday night at 9 on HSE.
The older they are, the harder they hit. The Champions Tour takes to the courts with more than just players. We're talking legends.
Wednesday night on HSE.
You're back at Sam Houston Race Park. Wednesday, October 12th, the season begins. The Thoroughbreds are back. More thrills, more winnings, more power. Wednesday, October 12th, the incredible Thoroughbred season returns at Sam Houston Race Park. Find out why they call it horsepower.
Welcome back to the Summit in Houston. Second period intermission. The Arrows leading the San Diego Gulls by a score of 3-2. Adam Gordon along with Russ Small, and the Arrows look like they may have been in a little bit of trouble to start that period after San Diego got the first goal, but we talked about the composure. They came right back to rattle off three unanswered goals.
Well, Adam, I think San Diego came out much better. The Arrows were flustered a bit. San Diego came out hot and heavy to start that second period, and they scored early. They scored 40 seconds into the period, and it really gave San Diego a lift. They had the first seven shots on goal in that period, and the Arrows really could have kind of laid down at that moment, but they didn't, and they came back with the next three goals of the game, played great on specialty teams with a couple of power play goals and a shorthanded goal, and a good comeback there to a 3-1 lead, and then San Diego comes back to make it 3-2, but it should be a wild and crazy third period here. 3-2 the score, and Beaufay started it with that wraparound.
Yeah, we'll look at it at the 42nd mark. Beaufay, kind of that strange wraparound as Lilly gets an assist on that, and it was 1-0 in favor of the San Diego Gulls, but at 10:28, that's what started the three unanswered goals. Graham Townsend from Mark Freer and Scott O'Neill. What a pass Freer put to him.
That great pass by Freer. That's what set up Graham Townsend. All he had to do was one time it into an open net, and he did. That got us even, and it got the Arrows started.
So it was 1-1 at that point, and we move to the 11:47 mark, and your guest, Murray Eaves, he held it. He held it from Chitteroni and Shargorodsky, and he buried it, and he gave the Arrows a 2-1 lead. Then at 16:06, the guy that's on fire, us, Clayton Young from Tippett and McKee.
All he had to do was put it home. Got the great pass from Dave Tippett. I think the Gulls were looking a little bit like he might try to drop the puck a little higher to Murray Eaves, who was setting up there. They looked at Eaves. He looked at Clayton Young. He gave it to Clayton Young, and Young put it home on the power play. At that point, the Arrows had a 3-1 lead, but it didn't last even a minute.
Nope, because the Gulls come back just under the 17-minute mark. 16:59, Brian Sullivan from Hubie McDonough and Lonnie Loach, and what a pretty goal this was from Brian Sullivan.
Hey, as pretty as the Gulls were by the Arrows, so was this a pretty goal by Brian Sullivan. The McDonough pass was very sharp. Sullivan just one-timed it home, and you got to give them credit, too, sometimes. They made it 3-2. The Arrows lead in the shots on goal department through a couple of periods, 23-20, and there's been some good wide-open play. There's been some good goaltending. We've had five goals in the second period. It sets us up for a real good third period here.
Oh, I can't wait. It's going to be a very exciting 20 minutes of action. We'll have more from the Summit in Houston right after this.
October? Well, check out HSE's October lineup. The Arrows and Stars pull out the blades to carve up the ice.
Schumann.
The Southland, SWC, SEC, and Pac-10 look to throw some treats and hand out some tricks. And the women of the SWC are bringing out the spice.
Yikes!
Still looking for some thrills? Well, tune in to HSE in October.
The name of the game is speed. Flying on steel blades across an arena of ice, stopping on a dime. Houston has a new way of flying. They're called the Arrows, and they're Houston's newest pro team. They'll be earning their wings every day. Bringing you thrills and chills will be their goal.
Sunday on HSE.
Best Team Outdoors features the best block of outdoor programming in the Southwest. A group of the finest sportsmen ever assembled to help you catch more fish, have better hunts, and enjoy the great outdoors. True sportsmen practice catch and release, conservation, and preservation of nature. But they bring something home as well. A great time.
attention. School is now in session. Watch Texas high school football's brightest stars shine. Coast to coast. Zone to zone. The Alamo High School Extra. Sunday mornings at 9 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. on HSE.
Today's Houston Aeros broadcast is being brought to you in part by Coors Light. Reach for Coors Light, the silver bullet, and keep on moving.
We're back at the Summit on HSE with the Aeros leading the visiting San Diego Gulls by the score of 3-2. I'm Russ Small with Adam Gordon. A terrific night here tonight. Good game. Aeros leading by one, but 20 exciting minutes yet to come here tonight between the Aeros and the San Diego Gulls. Right now, though, let's take time out for good health.
Time Out for Good Health is presented by Columbia HCA Healthcare Corporation, a new commitment in healthcare together.
Welcome to Time Out for Good Health. I'm Dr. Charles Baker, an orthopedic surgeon and team physician for the Houston Aeros. Today we're going to talk about athletic conditioning. Let's go downstairs to the Aeros Conditioning Laboratory. One of the jobs of the medical team is to oversee physical fitness and conditioning of the athletes. With us today is Jerry Mines. Jerry is a head trainer with Houston Aeros. He was formerly a head trainer with Houston Oilers. Jerry's going to talk to us a little bit today about the types of conditioning that athletes undergo. This includes aerobic, anaerobic, and strength conditioning. Jerry, could you give us a little information on those subjects?
Thank you, Dr. Baker. We're here in the Aerodrome at the Aeros Sports Conditioning Laboratory, and we're going to give you a little overview of some of the pieces of equipment that we have available to us to do our conditioning. We have several pieces of equipment that are cardiovascular or aerobic in nature. That consists of bicycles, stair climbers, and treadmills, all used for a cross-training effect where our athletes don't get into the rut of doing the same piece of equipment all the time. We also have available lots of pieces of anaerobic equipment, which is predominantly strength training equipment or weightlifting equipment that is used to gain muscle mass and overall general strength.
Remember to always check with your physician before beginning a new exercise program. Please join us next game for another edition of Time Out for Good Health.
Time Out for Good Health was presented by Columbia HCA Healthcare Corporation, a new commitment in healthcare together.
Hi, everyone. Steve Allen here to tell you about an important breakthrough that lets you hear a whisper up to 70 feet away. It's the Whisper XL, an amazing electronic earpiece that lets you hear a pin drop from across the room. The same way binoculars magnify your vision, this tiny device magnifies your hearing. Just slip on the Whisper, turn up the volume, and you're ready for super hearing like never before. Don't turn up the TV. Turn on the Whisper XL. Similar devices sell in catalogs for $200 and more. But if you call now, the Whisper XL can be yours for just $29.95. Think of it, just $29.95 for super powerful hearing. Give us a call and turn up the volume.
To order your Whisper XL, have your credit card ready and call 1-800-423-2121 or send check or money order for $29.95 plus $5.50 shipping and handling to Department H, P.O. Box 4943, Omaha, Nebraska. For faster service, call 1-800-423-2121.
It's time to get dirty, because Saturday is game day. Before you head out to the stadium, get psyched about the day's action with conference analysis and coaching insights. Get the inside scoop on what's going on week after week with your favorite team. And go beyond the X's and O's and into the huddle. Whether it's a grudge match against your rival or just another conference game, these coaches will be here every week to explain the game plan. Stay in the game. Saturdays on HSE.
Welcome back to the Summit in Houston. Adam Gordon along with Russ Small. 3-2. The Aeros leading the Gulls here in the second intermission. And let's take a look at tonight's highlights here in that second period. And there were quite a few of them.
Well, they had five goals. I mean, we had no goals in the first period. We had five in the second period. And it started very, very early. At the 42nd mark, a wraparound by Beaufay. And he just kind of slid it by Rob Dobson for 1-0 score.
But the Arrows come right back there on a nice, nice goal by Graham Townsend. Credit Freer with a great pass, but then this goal by Murray Eaves.
Chiaroni sent him in free. Eaves pulls it to the backhand and slides it by Bester.
And then this play with Dave Tippett feathering a beautiful pass to Clayton Young. Nowhere to put it but in the net, and you can see the reaction of Mark Ferner. He goes, oh my, where did I miss him? But then right back the goals come.
Yeah, we saw a lot of great passes, and there was one from McDonough to Sullivan, and Brian Sullivan just puts it home rather easily for a 3-2 score. The Arrows do lead. They were outshot in the second period 11-9, but lead in the shots on goal in the game 23-20. And four penalties for San Diego, 8 minutes, five penalties against the Arrows for 10 minutes. And maybe the big difference in the game at this moment is that the Arrows, and we talked about it earlier, the power plays. Tonight, they are 2 of 3, and they've held San Diego to 1 of 4, so fewer chances and one more goal, and it's a one-goal difference, 3-2 on the big board.
You know, we talked about the composure factor and the fact that the Arrows in their last two games have squandered leads at key points of the game. This is a very key point. You come into the third period with a 3-2 lead. You get the next goal, you're not only in the driver's seat, I mean, you're in a great position to win this hockey game.
Yeah, it still won't be over, but you're right. Next goal could be very, very important. I can remember saying in opening night here when they were down, I think, 2-1, that I thought the next goal was going to belong to the team that won this game. Yeah, that night, if Atlanta had scored to go up 3-1, I thought they were going to hold on. Conversely, I thought if the Arrows could get even, they could go on to win the game. It took shootout to do it, but they did it. And I think that could be the same situation here tonight. If the Arrows can get a two-goal lead, thus score first here in the third period, I think tonight they will hold on to it. I think they might press a little bit, however, if San Diego gets back even.
Please answer me this, though, Russ. First four games of the season, yeah, the Arrows are 1-2-1, but they've all been one-goal contests. Are we going to get another one of those tonight?
I don't know. You know, I said to Terry Ruskowski before the game, I'm getting tired of these nail-biters. Give us a laugher for a change. I know he'd enjoy a game where his team wins by 5 or 6 goals. It doesn't look like tonight is going to be the night, but I think at this moment, he just wants to win this hockey game. It's been a good game. It's been an exciting game. His team leads by 1 going into the third period, and he needs a win here tonight.
Let's quickly take a look at some upcoming games that the Arrows have. Of course, Sunday night, a game that you'll see here on HSC Plus we'll have for you on KNUZ Radio. The Atlanta Knights, defending Turner Cup champions, come in. 4 o'clock, we're on the air with that game. And then the 21st, the Arrows are back on the road into Las Vegas, and hopefully the only thing they'll lose on that is a little bit of cash.
Hey, put a dollar on green for me, will you? Spin the wheel one time. That'll be a fun trip. And then right back here against Peoria, and that'll be Warren Moon Appreciation Night, and that'll be a lot of fun to see Warren that night, and the fans I know will come out and honor him. He looked so good on Monday night, leading his team to a Monday night victory. Tomorrow night, we got a pretty good football game here in this town. I'll be calling the action on the Oilers Radio Network and KTRH, and the Oilers and Cleveland Browns tomorrow night, and that'll be a good game.
All right, we're set to drop the puck for period number 3, and the captain has turned on the seatbelt sign for what should be an outstanding ride here in the third as the Arrows win the draw, and from right to left they'll come. Clayton Young dumps the puck in 5 more seconds. You'll get Marshall and Townsend back, but an icing call on the Arrows, so we'll have to wait a second before they can come back. 3-2 hockey game in favor of the Houston Arrows.
And you know Terry Ruskowski has told his guys, remember what happened in the second period. San Diego came out and they jumped on you right away and they got a goal. Now you know San Diego wants to come out and jump on you again here in the third period, so you know, take it easy, be calm, play well these first couple of minutes as things settle in. So they're wary of these first couple of minutes, and the faceoff now to the left of Dobson.
Crowd tonight, 7,502, and they're being entertained with another great hockey game. And Shargorodsky, big drive and a glove save made by Bester. And that's one thing I know Terry Ruskowski would love to see a lot more of, and that's Oleg Shargorodsky firing the puck.
Well, he's had some success lately, scoring goals and assists. He has played well out here tonight, has an assist on the Murray Eaves shorthanded goal. And this one here a moment ago, he just kind of lets fly. Good hard shot, never really threatened to get by Alan Bester, but if you shoot enough, once in a while, something goes crazy along the way and gets in. You got to make the goaltender work, and he made Bester work. And if nothing else, it leads to a face-off coming right here in the circle to the right of Besker. So even if you go back, if the Arrows were to control on this face-off, keep the puck in the zone and score, you go back to a guy who's not even on the ice, and Oleg Shargorodsky, and say, hey, it was the shot he took that forced Besker to hold on that ultimately, eventually, led to a scoring chance. And that's the way this game works.
Off the draw, the Arrows have got it. That hit the skate of Pellerin back to the line. Hunt held it in. Now back to center ice, and here is Mike Pope. He'll walk through the neutral zone and into the Arrow zone, trying to move around Brian McKee, but Brian stayed with him stride for stride. Good play there. Now McKee covers up the puck, and he got a little fancy with it, but picked up by Freer. Now Freer, right side. Knee pass just eludes Arneil, and the goals are there to shoot it back in. Out of the net, Rob Dobson. We haven't played quite a minute yet in this third period, and the Arrows with a one-goal lead at 3-2. Here's Brian McKee. Spanks the puck off the wall, but not out. Sacco held it in. Here's a drive. That's whistled and deflected. And now the puck resting for Pellerin, and he'll move it to center ice just barely, but the goals turn it around. Here is Sacco now. He's muscled off the puck by McKee. Stays with it, though, and sends it back to his own blue line for Darren Van Imp. On the left side, he's bumped by Pellerin, and now to Scott Arneil as he crosses the blue line. Here is Arneil. Has a Memorial Cup ring when he played for the Peterborough Petes about 12 years ago. Now the puck picked up by San Diego in behind the net. Here is Jason Marshall now, with a minute and a half gone by in the third in a 3-2 hockey game. Marshall sends the puck ahead. Cleared by San Diego to center ice, but Valamont is there for Houston to shoot the puck back into the goal zone. Here's Van Imp. Picks up the loose puck behind the net, off the glass to the line. Not out. Held in Shargorodsky. His drive blocked by Marshall, and he'll advance it up the right wing. His pass to McDonough, stripped away. And now Darren Van Imp, he'll advance it and shoot it into Arrows territory. High off the glass, takes a weird hop as Sullivan tried to get a shot away. Now it's McDonough. He centered it, but it was tipped away by Shargorodsky, trying to clear the zone, and now it's Mike Yeo. Yeo to center up the left side. Mike Yeo through the neutral zone as he hits the line. Nice move, cuts in, but he's offside. Faceoff brought back to center ice. We'll take a break. 3-2 Arrows here on the Arrows Broadcasting Network.
It's time for friends to fly free on Southwest Airlines.
Wake up and smell the coffee.
And people are friendlier than ever. Just make reservations at least a day in advance and buy your round-trip ticket at Southwest's regular low unrestricted fare, and a friend flies with you, free, anywhere we fly.
Yo, Dad, what do you think?
Friends fly free on Southwest, the low-fare airline. Call 1-800-IFLY-SWA.
Off center ice, Adam Gordon along with Russ Small. What a hockey game. It's been a lot of fun.
It's been a great game, and it's 3-2 in favor of the Arrows, and we've got just under 18 minutes to play in the third.
Now the puck back at a right point. Here is Jakes trying to redirect one in there. A centering pass taken by Donatelli. It's worked up to the line, not out. Riker couldn't advance it, and now it's Chartier. He'll move to center ice. Up the left wing boards, he'll come as he shoots it into Arrow territory. Is picked up down the side by Ruchin, and that play whistled down on the offside. Faceoff brought back to center with 2.5 gone by in the third, 3-2 Arrows.
I'll tell you something I've noticed here. The Arrows defensemen, when they're in their own end and they're trying to move the puck up ice, have been using the dasher boards a lot. They've been taking it along the boards to the right or the left, either by skating it up there, but usually by firing it around there and trying to get it to one of the wingers. San Diego has started to play the boards. They know where they're trying to go. If the Arrows get smart, they're going to look to the boards and then take it right up the middle of the ice, and they should be able to get a break somewhere in this third period.
Talking with Dave Tippett before the game, that was the comment he felt that the problem was with the Denver game, was that the Grizzlies play the wall, and that was their game plan, and the Arrows never took advantage of it. That's something they may have to try here if the Gulls continue to pinch down the walls. Puck brought into the Arrow zone. Back goes Chris Foy, watched along by Reichert. It's picked up by San Diego. It's passed, deflected away. Now got it. We're going to get a whistle, and we're going to get a penalty as a shot blocked by Dobson. Now Dreger and St. Cyr glare at one another, and the lines can get in there to separate them, but I think we're going to get a Houston Arrow penalty here.
We are definitely going to get an Arrows penalty, and it may be St. Cyr who's going out. That's why he was so intent on bringing somebody with him. The other penalty box now open, but closed again. It's only going to be St. Cyr
who's going out, and so the Arrows will be shorthanded. We talked a little bit earlier about how the Arrows have done well on the power play tonight and have limited the goals to one power play goal on four chances. Well, they're going to get a fifth chance here. St. Cyr goes out for tripping at the three-minute mark of the third period.
Well, in a one-goal hockey game going into the third period now, all of a sudden where you're playing physical hockey, you got to kind of watch the discipline factor, and the Arrows gave up a needless penalty back in the second period, and that's what got the Gulls back into this one at 3-2, so they're going to have to dig down for one here and kill this thing off. Face off in the circle to the right side of Rob Dobson. It'll be Freer against McDonough. McDonough lines up in the circle there with Lonnie Loach. Boy, those two work so well together. Also out there for San Diego, it's Ryan Sullivan who has the goal that drew them with him one. Now Arneal tossed out of the circle, so Freer couldn't do it, Arneal couldn't do it, so here's Carl Vallemont, who in his own right mind never planned on taking a faceoff.
You don't see many defensemen take him.
He'll take it against McDonough, and it was won cleanly by McDonough. Left side for Sacco, getting set top of the circle. Down low now, it's worked back to Sacco as the Gulls work patiently along the perimeter. Here is Loach, fakes the shot, now bends it back top of the slot. A drive by Ferner, that's deflected by Freer. It's out to center ice, and then Ferner fell. Lynch stays tough for the puck. Here's Sacco now, left side as he crosses the line. Try to redirect one in there. It's picked up by Vallemont, and he'll just calmly turn and lug it all the way down the ice, and Pester's there to get in front of it. 1.5 remaining in the St. Cyr Minor, 16.5 to play in the third period, and a 3-2 hockey game. Here is Shargorodsky, and he clears it down the ice. Now the goals turn it around. Loach redirects it up for McDonough. Goes into the Arrow zone, but Hunt is there, and he'll bring it ahead now for Cinneroni. Hits the line with Young, dropped it for him. Young shoots, Pester! The right pad save. Cinneroni was a little late getting there. If he's maybe a step earlier, he's got a shot at maybe tipping that one in.
Arrows already have one shorthanded goal tonight. They were looking for number two.
Here's a chance now as the Arrows try to bring it in, but that's a two-line offside. And they bring the faceoff back into the Arrow zone. Boy, the referee, I don't think, thought it was, because he's talking to Mario Cinneroni, but they're going to say that that's a two-line pass. I'd love to see that one again, but they're going to bring it back into the Arrow zone.
Yeah, I guess that's what they're calling. The fans here, not knowing that it's a two-line pass, they're calling. Yeah, it's definitely a two-line pass. It was a good call. But the fans here were looking for the offside of the blue line, and they saw that Cinneroni had stopped and not gone in the zone, and they thought maybe the officials were anticipating the offside and blew the whistle, but indeed it was the correct call on a two-line pass.
4 minutes played in the third, 3-2 hockey game. Eaves against Beaufay. Under a minute to go in the St. Cyr Minor, but a good job by Eaves as he spanks that down the ice.
Even Cinneroni thought it was an offside they were calling, and he went right away to say, look, I never did get in the zone. And they quickly explained to him, nope, it wasn't on you. It was a two-line pass.
Here's Darren Van Imp now for the San Diego Gulls. His lead pass up for Donatelli. Now up the left side, Lily Wine shoots in that knuckleballed line of the net. Now tipping the battle with Van Imp. There's skate to skate now. Here's a chance for Beaufay. He'll roll it in behind the net. Lily, left point, Ferner. Right point, Van Imp, the drive, and a glove save made by Dobson, and he'll hold on. Three, make it 4.5 played in this third period. 3-2 Arrows, half a minute remaining to St. Cyr.
Good glove save by Dobson. The good thing, too, because while the Arrows are shorthanded 5-on-4, they were almost 5-on-3 there because Tippett had lost his stick. It had broken, and you're not allowed to play with a broken stick. If your stick breaks, you got to drop it right where you are and play without a stick, or if you're able to get over to the side of your bench and get another stick, but he didn't have time, so he was really kind of helpless out there.
Here's Van Imp now to Ferner on the left side as the goal still on the power play for 20 seconds. Donatelli, quick pass. Van Imp looks for Donatelli, eludes him, though, and now Hunt, he misplayed the puck behind his own net. Here's a chance for San Diego. Donatelli, base of the circle, sends one back for Ferner. He shoots, but that's blocked in. Freer will get that off the glass to center ice. 5 minutes gone by in the third, and the penalty now over to St. Cyr, but the Gulls bring it in. Right side, Beaufay trying to make the move around Foy, cannot do it. Here is Eaves as he will gallop behind his cage and shoot it to the line. Not out, Van Himp held it in. Take the win, Hoffman Dobson had to alertly get in front of that, and we'll take a timeout. 3-2, the Arrows lead it. We're back after this.
Sam Houston Race Park. Wednesday, October 12th, the season begins. The thoroughbreds are back. More thrills, more winnings, more power,
Wednesday, October 12th, the incredible thoroughbred season returns at Sam Houston Race Park. Find out why they call it horsepower.
Lead at 3-2, 14-48 to play in this third period. Adam Gordon along with Russ Small. Once again, we're entertained to another tight one. Here is Chartier on the right point. Lets a shot go and that ricocheted wide. I don't know if Dobson saw that, but it went wide of the net.
He heard it. Hit the boards behind the net.
Now the puck, base of the fire circle in the arrow zone. It's picked up by Freer. He'll get it up for Arneal. Can't clear. Chartier held it in. Arrow's putting a little bit of pressure. Checked at the goal's putting a little pressure on now. Here is Reichert, pinned by Jakes. They muscle up along the fire boards. Jakes trying to get it up for Pellerin. They're in a pretty good battle there. Jakes has got it to the line, and it's out to center. It's good play by the lunging Scott Arneal. Now the puck sizzles up over the glass and out of play, and it's a souvenir for a fan. We'll keep that for, I'm sure, a nice momentum of tonight's hockey game. 3-2 Arrows.
Again, though, that last San Diego opportunity, the chance, the pressure they were putting on the zone started with the Arrows trying to clear the puck out of the zone up along the board. The Gulls were right there to stop it and force some pressure. I still think eventually the Arrows are going to catch on to the fact that while they're trying to pinch along the boards, something's going to open and they're going to send somebody quickly through center ice to take a lead pass and maybe even go in for a breakaway.
Off the faceoff, here's Oleg Shargorodsky for the Arrows. Dumps the puck into the San Diego zone. Bester out of the cage. He'll slow it and roll it to Mark Ferner now. Here is Ferner in behind his net, and he'll set up the breakout now with 6 minutes gone by in the third and a 3-2 hockey game in favor of the Houston Arrows. Pass eludes Manilok, and the Arrows just shoot it back toward the blue line, but the Bulls are there to turn it around. Drager did the honors. Now the Arrows will try it. Here's Shargorodsky left side. Tries to dump it in. That's blocked by Ferner, and now the Bulls will give it a try. It is Rupchin. He got it ahead for Reichert. Shot into Arrow territory, and back goes Shargorodsky. Line change on for the goal, so a chance for the Arrows to break it out. Here is a chance for Clayton Young. He's wrapped up by McDonough, but it's given away to Mike Yo now. Yo cuts in, shoots, it's in, Bister! And the rebound went just wide. Great play by the 21-year-old Mike Yo, but Bester made a sparkling stop on him, and we get a whistle and a two-line pass, and then we get a collision. Curtis Hunt gets in there, and we'll sort all this out when we return. 13-14 to play in the third. Arrows by one. We're back after this.
An ordinary beer can, barely alive.
Gentlemen, we can rebuild it. We have the technology. We have the capability to make the world's first bionic can. Coors Light will be that can. Better than it was before. Taller, thinner, silver. Next on the Coors Light Channel.
Face off inside the San Diego zone. 3-2 hockey game. 13 minutes, 14 seconds to play in the third.
Good opportunity a moment ago with Mike Yo coming in from the wing, trying to stuff it to the short side, but Bester was there.
Face puck at center ice now for Curtis Hunt. They'll roll it ahead, but it's picked up by McDonough, trying to advance it. Now a chance for Tippett. Center ice through the neutral zone. He comes with a drive, and Bester had that handcuff him, but he got a right pad on it. Now the puck in behind. Here come the Gulls. They'll jump on it, and it's Jason Marshall. Loach trying to advance it. Picked up Cittaroni. He is tied up by Hubie McDonough. Here is a chance for Cittaroni as he rolls it into San Diego goal territory. Bester down. Trying to roll it ahead, and then Marshall is giving a little extra shove into his own net, courtesy, I believe, of Eaves, and that'll bring the faceoff to center ice. 39 left, and now we've got
Dave Tippett involved.
He's not happy about something. He is right in the middle of it. We got Brian Sullivan in there.
Yeah, he got hit in the back of the head. I don't blame him for not being too happy.
Lonnie Loach is being escorted as well. So I think we'll get coincidental minors here, and we'll play some 4-on-4 hockey, I believe. 12:39 left in the third, a 3-2 hockey game, and open ice, who do you think that favors? It seems like San Diego is the better skating team.
Yeah, it has seemed that way, but, you know, the Arrows have skaters. It's not like it's going to be 15 against 15. You have all your best skaters out there. It's 4-on-4 here in the
this situation. Plenty of room on the ice, but the Arrows have skaters. I don't think the Gulls have such an advantage that this is going to necessarily favor them.
Terry Ruskowski trying to select his line from the bench there, and he says, all right, we're 4-on-4. Let me have Freer and Arneal, Jakes and Foy.
Unsportsmanlike conduct. The calls here on Lonnie Loach of San Diego and Dave Tippett of the Arrows. So they both go out to cool it for a couple of minutes.
Now here's a chance. Arneal, a quick drive, but that's deflected by Van Imp. And it's Darren Van Imp up the left side. And now Beauvais, he'll cross the line, trying to beat Foy. Nice move. Let's the shot go, but Foy stayed with him nice and got a skate on that, and he blocked the shot. Here is Jakes. Long lead pass to center ice for Freer. 2-on-2 with Arneal. They cross it up. Here's Freer as he crosses the line. Nice move.
Lace them up, because it's time to drop the puck and start skating. As Brute presents Hockey Week gives you the goals, saves, and hits you may have missed or want to see again. Face off, Fridays at 6 on HSE. It's the power, the speed, the risk. No other racing event demands the best drivers, and nothing compares to the excitement of the APVA Race Series.
Does not come into the zone. They do not get a 2-on-1 opportunity, and they do not score. Shogorodsky misses his check right up near center ice, and Marshall squeezes by him, and when he makes the pass, it's then a 2-on-1, and one pass later, it is Donatelli putting it home, and it is a tie hockey game.
So once again, the Arrows can't hold on to the lead, and they find themselves in a 3-3 deadlock with 11:35 to play in this third period. Here is Curtis Hunt now, and we said the next goal would be huge, and the San Diego Gulls have it, and they've knotted this thing up at 3. Now the puck picked up by Dreger, and he'll roll it into Houston Arrow territory. Curtis Hunt will lug the puck up the right wing, and away he will skate. Here comes Curtis Hunt now, looks up ice and just gently pumps the puck in. Icing if the Gulls get there, and Ferner is there to touch it, and icing is called with 11 minutes, 11 seconds to play in the third. We're tied at 3.
Well, a good shot by Donatelli, but he had the great pass out in front, and it was a fairly easy pickings for his first goal of the year. Lark Donatelli ties this game up at 3-3. Again, really the play made at center ice. Conversely, the mistake made at center ice by the Arrows. And eventually a 2-on-1 break-in for San Diego. They convert, and they've knotted it up here at 3-3.
Face-off at the circle to the right side of Rob Dobson. Here's Murray Eaves against Huey McDonough, and McDonough wins the draw. Picked up now by Dreger, slaps it for McDonough behind the net. He's wrapped up by Hunt as they go colliding along the end wall. Now Hunt again. He is wrapped up by McDonough as they go skate to skate along the end wall. We're tied at 3. It is a pretty good scrum now. As play goes on, though, Hunt shakes off the check. McDonough popped it free. Now Sullivan trying to advance it, cannot. Now McDonough again, and he's given a rough ride by Hunt. Hunt giving him the lumber pretty good. McDonough wanted a penalty, won't get it. Now the Arrows come away. Here's Cinneroni with a man to beat. Cinneroni trying to move in. Mario is drilled into the corner with a solid check from Ferner. Now Ferner has the puck. He's tied up by Cinneroni. Tony Mario trying to work him out, not working for the puck. Now Loach and Tippett go at it. Here is Eaves looking out in front. The puck was centered, but McDonough was there, and we're going to get a whistle and a penalty. We're going to get a holding minor. And the Arrows, I think, are going to get a power play, and we'll bring it to you when we return. 10.5 to play in the third, tied at 3, and we'll be back right after this.
HSE, it's music to your eyes.
Face-off in the circle to the right side of Alan Bester. 2 minutes up on the board now to Barry Dreger, and let's see how the Arrows do on their power play, but they lose the draw, and the Gulls will shoot it down the ice.
Moments ago, where it was 4-on-4 on the ice, you kind of suggested that that might favor San Diego, and unfortunately, you were right, and they scored the equalizer. 3-3, but the Arrows on the power play.
Here's a chance now. Arneal crosses the line, trying to slide it through Van Impe, could not do it, and Darren Van Impe gets it out to center ice. Back goes Shargorodsky. He's watched by Bo Fay, but he got it up for Mark Freer, trying to turn it up ice. Here comes Freer down the right side. Arrows on the power play for another minute and a half. Freer trying to muscle it along the boards. It comes to the line. Just barely held in by Shargorodsky. That almost looked like it came out, but he held it in. Now on the left side, Van Impe. He can't clear. Arrows trying to get the puck and control it, but right now it's pinned along the wall. Vallemont in there. He's muscled there by Sacco. Still doing a good job, and finally Sacco was able to push it down the ice.
They'll have to go back and regroup. This power play has just never gotten going, but they've got another minute in it. Here they come.
Now Townsend, his pass intercepted, and this puck will go down the ice. And it's stopped by Robbie Dobson with 52 seconds remaining in this Arrow power play. Here comes Brian McKee from right to left. He'll spank it into Gull territory. First one there. It was Young trying to redirect it out in front. A battle for the puck, and it's picked up by the Gulls and wristed down the ice with 9 minutes to play in the third. Tied at 3, and we're down to half a minute remaining in this Arrows power play. But the Gulls have the puck. Once again, they'll shoot it down the ice. Here is Clayton Young. Run off the puck by McDonough, but it's picked up by Foy. Lead pass just to Lutz Murray Eaves. Icing if the Gulls get there, and that is a no-no, getting an icing call on the power play. And the faceoff will go back into the Arrows zone with 21 seconds remaining in the power play. Tied at 3.
1 minute and 39 seconds gone on this power play, Adam, and I don't believe the Arrows have had control of the puck in the offensive zone at all in this power play. That's not good.
And to make matters worse now, they've got a faceoff in their own end. It'll be to the right, make that the left of Rob Dobson. 8:42 left in the third. Dave Tippett, who has an assist in this hockey game, he'll come off, and now the line of Mario Cittaroni, Brian Pellerin, and Mike Yeo. They'll try to work out something here on this power play. Faceoff controlled by the Arrows. Brian McKee will motor in behind his net and pull up and set up the breakout now. Here comes Brian McKee as he starts up ice from right to left. McKee shooting into the San Diego zone. First one there, Cittaroni, but it took a weird hop. Now it is Yeo, base of the left circle, cuts in, shoots best of the save. Rebound in front, they bang away at him, and they couldn't get control of the puck. The puck was sitting between the circles, just saying, shoot me, and that's what the Gulls did. They shot it down the ice.
Good opportunity, just goes by the board.
Now Cittaroni, he'll give it to Yeo, and he'll just bang it out to the center, and that'll do it as the power play now over teams at 5-a-side. Puck dumped into the Arrow zone. McKee will spank it along the wall, and it'll go all the way down the ice for yes, another icing call as Marshall is back, and they'll bring the faceoff back into the Arrow zone with under 8 minutes to play in the third, and we're tied at 3, and we'll be right back after this.
When you want the real story, go to the clubhouse. Get into the action and discuss the hottest topics with informed hosts and some of sports' biggest names. Live on Clubhouse Special Edition. Monday nights at 7 on HSE.
Attention, school is now in session. Watch Texas high school football's brightest stars shine coast to coast, zone to zone. The Alamo High School Extra, Sunday mornings at 9 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. on HSE.
Face off in the circle to the left side of Rob Dobson. Arrow goes three, gulls three. Here's Van Imp, right point shot. That was right on, and Dobson got a piece of it. Now Jakes, can he get it out of the zone? He'll shoot it off the wall, but he won't get it out. Marshall held it in right point. He was creamed along the wall by Arneal. Here's Donatelli. He tries to move it. It hit a leg in front, but Jakes was there to gather the puck. He'll shoot it off the glass to the line, and not out, though. Marshall held it in. Popped it into the far corner. Here's Curtis Hunt now. He tries to control the puck. Hunt rolls it up the right side for Freer. Rink-wide pass for Jakes as he starts the rush. Jakes shoots it in. Bester won't get to it. It'll go to the far corner. Freer won't get there either. Rooch into the line. Here's a chance. Jakes for the arrow. The bouncing puck that just went wide. I don't know if Bester saw that one. He had big Scott Arneal in front of him, but the arrow's back to their own blue line. Mark Freer now starts up ice for St. Cyr. Hits the line. St. Cyr trying to cut it out in front, but that puck wristed away by the goals. Now Oleg Shargorodsky back, and that's icing with 7 minutes to play in the third and a 3-3 hockey game.
Gary Ryskowski needs to find the right combination right now. He's got to decide who is it that's going to come up with the big play, the big goal for his team. He's got to help them keep their composure. They should be used to it by now. In four games, they played 4 one-goal games. This now number five, and this looks like it could be a one-goal game as well. So it will be. Would it be one of his kids? Would it be one of his veterans, like a Townsend, like a Murray Eaves, like a Scott Arneal? Hope it's one of those guys.
Face off to the left of Bester. Arrows win the draw. Quick shot by Ballum off the stick. Save made by Bester. Now a centering pass. That hit a leg, and it's picked up by Lilly. And shot out to the neutral zone. It's golfed ahead by Bofe, and it's worked right back into the arrow zone. Here's a chance now. Ferner back in his own end. Watched by Townsend. He'll give it up to Dranger in behind the net. He was harassed by Mike Yo. Arrows doing a good job. It's a giveaway in the shot. Corner. It's picked up by Clayton Young. Young looking for Townsend. He's wrapped up by Ferner, though, and now Sacco will move it from left to right. It is David Sacco through the neutral zone. Crosses the arrow blue line. Dropped it back. Here's the chance. Bofe, the shot just went wide. The rebound took a weird hop in front. Ballamont can't clear, and we're going to get a penalty coming up here. A delayed call, and as Yo plays it, that should have been a hand pass. Play on. Well, the arrows will shoot it down the ice, and here's chance now as it's played by Marshall. Cross-checking minor coming up to the goals, and they'll bring the arrows back on the power play with a chance to go up.
Well, you can't ask for more than that, right? 5:56 to play in the hockey game. You're in a tie game. You're at home. The fans need a little something to get excited about. You want a goal to try to win this game and to get a power play. They got to get something going. Ballamont a moment ago at him with a great opportunity in the slot. I think if he puts it on goal, he beats Bester. Bester was just locked in there. Didn't have much of a choice but stand still and hope the puck hits him or goes wide. It went wide. And now the penalty called on Sacco of San Diego. And so he goes out for a couple of minutes. David Sacco with the penalty and the arrows with a power play. The circle to the right of Bester, that's where they'll face it off.
Chinnerone, Eaves, and Tippett now with Foy and McKee. Here's Foy left side trying to center it. Here's a chance. Chinnerone can't get the backhand away. Now back to the line. McKee, a wrist shot deflected and goes to the near corner. McDonough got it to the line. It's out to center ice, but McKee will gather in the puck and the arrows will bring it right back in. Here's Mario Chinnerone trying to center. That's tipped away. Shot back down the ice. 1:39 left in the penalty to David Sacco. And Dobson out of the net. Arrows tied with the Gulls at three. What a hockey game as Chris Foy brings it up the left side. Foy dropped it back for Eaves. Screaming down the left side. It's Eaves for Tippett. Base of the left circle. Arrows on the power play. It is pass now back for Tippett. Looks for Eaves behind the net, but he stays with it. Back to the line. McKee wide. Shoots. Whistle. Just wide. Now Foy misplayed the pocket. Here on the goal. Short-handed. McDonough with Loach. McDonough left side makes the move, but he was bumped off the puck, and it's turned around by Chinnerone. Now Murray Eaves gallops into the San Diego zone. Here's Eaves, pulls up left side, drops it back. Arneal can't get the shot away, still with the puck though. Centered it, here's the chance. Chinnerone jammed one just wide. Now the puck for Eaves, it comes back to the line. Shargorodsky bumped by Loach, and the puck goes down the ice.
45 seconds left in the power play, some good pressure by the Arrows, but we're still locked in a 3-3 game.
They got the pressure, but never really did get any good shots yet on Alan Bester. Here's a weak pass intercepted by Ferner. Ballamont knocked him off the puck and a penalty coming up the car.
It's time to get pumped, because Larry North is ready to help you get into a healthier body. Whether you're young or old, isn't it about time you got fit? Weekday mornings at 7 on HSE.
The older they are, the harder they hit. The Champions Tour takes to the courts with more than just players. We're talking legends.
Wednesday night on HSE.
Face off in the circle to the left of Rob Dobson. Big opportunity now for the goals.
Well, mistake by Carl Vallimotti. He compounded a bad pass, losing the puck in his own end with a subsequent interference penalty. And now it's going to be a power play here in another 30 seconds for San Diego.
They'll get a minute and a half to work with on that power play, but first it's Ferner who will drift back in behind the net, and he'll start the rush out of his zone. He's watched by Freer. He'll work the pass to center ice. Whoop, miscommunication there by Beaufay and Donatelli, but Beaufay got back to the puck. He'll bring it into the arrow zone, but Sharnarodsky's there to sweep it out. The arrows trying to catch the goals changing. Here's Arneal, two on two with Freer. Now Freer right side, pulls up. Arrows are going to be short-handed. Here's the drive right on at Besser. A marvelous save as he had Arneal kind of draped all in front of him there and kind of screened on that, but Bester made a nice save.
That was as good a scoring chance as the Arrows have had in the third period. Great opportunity there. Really was a two-on-two, but they worked it so well that they found the trailer, and the shot comes from the left point, and it was a blistering shot, and there was a screen out there in front of Alan Bester, but he saw the puck, and he made the stop. Good, good opportunity for the Arrows with some nice play in the forward zone. It is now a San Diego power play. 1:27 still up there on the board. The penalty, the time left of the Carl Vallimotti interference penalty.
He's off to the right of Alan Bester. Eaves and Tippett with Foy and Hunt. And the Arrows, Eaves, who had a chance, but it was McDonough who won it. Now Ferner circles in the near side. Gave up the puck, but it's picked up by McDonough. Shoved it back in behind his net, and Sacco will be there. David Sacco, who usually watches the left point on the power play, he'll start the rush from left to right. Up for McDonough, crosses the arrow blue line. McDonough, cross ice pass, intercepted by Eaves. Can he get it out of there? He will. And the goals go back. 3.5 left in this one. We are tied at 3. Here is Curtis Hunt. Can he golf it out of there? Yes, he will. The goals are there to pick it up. Sacco, pass to the right side. Sullivan, got it for Loach. Went off the skates, and now it is Foy who will turn. Can he get it out? No, nice play by Ferner. Kind of looked like Kevin Mitchell going for one up there as he grabbed it over the arrow bench, kept it in play, and finally Eaves is there to shoot it down the ice.
Kevin Mitchell, the outfielder with the best barehanded catch you've ever seen.
Now the puck back for Ferner as he'll stop in behind his net. Penalty down to half a minute. And the goals will bring it from left to right. Ferner, pass to the right side for Donatelli. He'll go across the side. It'll go into arrow territory and picked up by McKee and spanked to center ice for Darren Van Imp. He drifts back to his own zone, shovels it ahead, and Sacco there to blister it into arrow territory. Now, here is McKee. He rolls it along the near side. Young, can he clear it? Yes, he will. It'll go down the ice. Chinaroni on his horse. He's got it. Chinaroni cuts in. Shot away, and he's going to draw a penalty, and the Arrows will be on the power play when we return. 3-3, our score.
Attention, school is now in session. Watch Texas high school football's brightest stars shine coast to coast, zone to zone. The Alamo High School Extra, Sunday mornings at 9 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. on HSE. It's the power, the speed, the risk. No other racing event demands the best drivers, and nothing compares to the excitement of the APVA Race Series.
Boy, this goal here, 3-3 our score, it was all Mario Cinaroni as he had a nice moving on goal here.
Well, you talked about it before, Adam, and you described it as pure effort, and indeed it was. That puck was there for the taking by Mario or David Sacco, and Mario just beat him to it and came up with the puck and got a good shot away, and Sacco had to bring him down, and Sacco's gone, and the Arrows will have a power play in one more second as there's a false start in the circle. In 1 second, Vallimotti comes out of the penalty box, and the Arrows will be on a power play, and there will be 2 minutes and 25 seconds left in the third period. We're tied at 3.
Freer against McDonough. And And McDonough wins the draw. Banamp rolled it down low for McDonough. He'll circle, wait, and blast it down the ice. 2:18 left in the third. Arrows with a minute 50 left on the power play as Carl Vallemont will drift back into his own zone.
Including tonight, Adam, San Diego has 6 third-period goals this year. Their opposition just 1.
Here's Shargorodsky. Dumps the puck into the Bester there. Good and clear. Now Freer, base of the right circle. Looks for Arneal. He kind of stumbled, so he couldn't get it to him. Now he will. Here's Arneal. Misplayed the puck in the corner. Scott Arneal pins it back to the line for Shargorodsky. Now for Freer. Couldn't catch up to the puck, and Loach is there. And he cleared. No, Vallemont got there to hold it in. Second effort to the line and out the center ice. 1:43 left in regulation, 1:15 left in the penalty, tied at 3. Here comes Arneal now, pulls up on the right side, a cross ice pass for Vallemont, moves down on the power play. Vallemont gets it in behind the net for Freer. Here is Mark Freer to the line. Shargorodsky had the puck hop off his stick. Now Vallemont a drive and a stick save made by Bester. Puck picked up by the goals and shot down the ice. Poor Shargorodsky, that puck doesn't hop, he gets a shot away.
Yeah, but eventually Vallemont got a shot. It was a lot of work for a not very good shot.
Shargorodsky had the goals caught in a line change, but unfortunately couldn't really do anything with it. The arrows are back at center. St. Cyr with 40 left on the power play. Drifts one into Bester. It's picked up by Dreger. He'll lob it to the line. McKee held it in. Sends it down for Young, and now Tippett. He's got St. Cyr all alone, but couldn't get it to him in front. Now the puck beats to the left circle for Foy. Gets it in behind the San Diego net. Tippett centered. Here's the chance to shot Bester with a right pad save as he bests St. Cyr, and the goals will shoot it down in the power play down to 15 seconds. Wow, what a play.
One more rush here. We're under 40 seconds left in the game.
Here is Chris Foy, left side, lead pass to Clayton Young. Hits the line. Young drops it back. Here's the drive right on the rebound. Out by Bester, and he'll hold on. And once again, Jerry St. Cyr had a chance, but Bester there to hold on to it with under half a minute to play in the third, and a 3-3 hockey game.
Couple of rebound chances for St. Cyr, and Bester was right on top of both of them. Initial save and a quick flip off St. Cyr on the rebound, and Bester with another save. The most shots on goal this season prior to this game for the Arrows, 38. Well, they're right at the 38 total tonight with 28 seconds left in regulation, and the faceoff set to come in the circle to the left of Bester, but we've got a timeout call as both teams will take the opportunity to discuss things. And the important things here, of course, Adam, is the Arrows know they've got the faceoff in the offensive zone. If they can win it cleanly, they want to know what they're going to set up. And San Diego, conversely, their concern right now is don't give one up quickly here. If you lose the faceoff, make sure you got your man or you got your spot and that you're playing well in the defensive end.
Well, we'll do it again Sunday as the Arrows and the Atlanta Knights go at it. Game time is at 4 o'clock, and that'll be our next telecast. We'll have it for you. Be sure to join Russ Small and myself. Are you ready for Atlanta again?
Hey, I'm not even ready for a shootout, which we're approaching tonight. 4 games this year prior to tonight, all decided by 1 goal. 2 of them decided in a shootout. The Arrows are 1 up, 1 down in shootouts. In their 2 shootout games, the home team has won each time. They lost at Denver. They won here over Atlanta. If we go to shootout tonight, I hope that holds up. Graham Townsend, of course, with the game winner in the shootout opening night against Atlanta. We've got 28.1 seconds to play in this one. We're tied at 3. The faceoff to come in the circle to the left of Alan Bester, who has made 35 saves tonight.
Let's set it up now with Young, Yo, St. Cyr, McKee, and Foy. The goals, I don't even have to look. You know McDonough's out there. You know Loach is out there. Marshall defensively with Ferner. As we said, a second remaining to Sacco. I'm sure he'll join here as soon as the penalty over. Face off left of Bester. Young is one of the best, but so is McDonough. But Young wins the draw. Here's the shot right on Bester. Save. Rebound. Stopped in there. Oh, my. And a big collision. Rebound. Score. They're going to wave it off. Clayton Young is going to plead his case. But I'll tell you what, the referee makes a pretty good call. Bernie DeGray say, I lost sight of the puck. Clayton Young had it, but everybody had stopped.
And it wasn't really even close. I mean, DeGrace, I'm up here and I'm watching the official, and DeGrace clearly has blown the whistle and whistled it dead. The puck was under people. He had lost sight of it, and it was clearly after that that Clayton Young, still poking away at it, poking away at it, poking away at it, comes up with it and fires it home. You know, you can argue that maybe it was a quick whistle, but it certainly was a whistle before the shot.
Boy, I would love to see this again, because look at the second save that Bester makes. He is down on his derriere and somehow gets the right pad. How he has the presence of mind to get the right pad out to stop St. Cyr on the rebound, I'll never know. If he doesn't get that right pad out there, look at the way this happens as we'll take another look at it. Watch Bester. He's down to make the first save. Now watch him on the second one. Get the right pad out there as St. Cyr was there. Oh, my.
St. Cyr is going to be seeing Bester in his dreams. St. Cyr on rebound shots has had three of them in the last 5 minutes and hasn't been able to put any of them by Alan Bester. I'm sure he's seen enough of Bester for a while. Well, that's why Bester lasted as long as he did in the NHL. Nine seasons between Toronto and Detroit. You know, he's not Johnny come lately. The guy's been around. He's made a lot of those saves through the years.
Face off will be to the left of Alan Bester. Hubie McDonough will come back out to take the face off. He's out there with Loach. And now Brian Sullivan. Defensively, they're going to go with Dreger. Or no, now Drager's going to come to the bench. Barry Dreger had lined up out there, but now they're going to go with Mitchell and Ferner. Big face-off here. Clayton Young did pretty well against McDonough the last time. We'll see how he does here. 22 and a half seconds to play in the third. 3-3 hockey game. Young, Yo, St. Cyr with Foy and with McKee. Crowd, well, a lot of the 7,500 on their feet. Here we go. Young against McDonough. Sticks down, drop of the puck, but the Gulls have got it. Puck came out in front. It'll go to center ice. 19 seconds left. Arrows quickly shoot it back in as out of the net, Bester. That's enough for San Diego to have a quick rush, though. Sullivan tipped it down the ice, but there's 10 seconds left. Is it icing? Yeah, it will be. So don't quite pack it in yet. 6 seconds left, and if Young can win one cleanly, perhaps a quick shot, but now we've got some pushing and shoving as one of the arrows down there, and it's kind of hard to see, but I think you got St. Cyr and Foy down there.
Yeah, Sullivan's down there as well. Jason Marshall is also down there. Everybody going to be broken up. I don't think there'll be any calls made here unless anything further breaks out. But you got 6.2 seconds left. And that icing on San Diego, kind of a mistake. There was no need for that. And you give a team 6 seconds and a face-off in the forward zone. 6 seconds is a lot of time. If you win a draw cleanly, you can get a good shot away. So it'd be great to see the arrows burn them here. But otherwise, I think we're going to OT and a little shootout again.
Face-off will be in the circle to the right of Bester. It would be 3 out of 5 contests, which we've needed a shootout.
That was Terry Ruskowski told me the other night. And I asked him, what do you think of shootouts? He says, I hate them unless we win. I don't mind them so bad, but otherwise I don't like them.
Face off between Clayton Young and Hubie McDonough again. Walt Kyle on his feet from the San Diego bench, barking out face-off directions. Team captain Hubie McDonough against Clayton Young. What a game. What a last few games this kid has had. Big face-off here now. Young trying to win it. He's got it, but it's into a scrum. 3 seconds left, and that's going to do it as the buzzer is going to sound, and we are through with regulation time. And, yes, we're going to another shootout tied at 3.
It'll be the Gulls' first shootout of this season. They come in here with a record of 1-2. The Arrows 1-1 in shootouts, as we said. They lost at Denver in a shootout, got the 1-point shootout tie. And they won at home here on opening night, on home opening night, against Atlanta on the Graham Townsend goal. He was, as I recall, the 8th shooter of the night for the Arrows. The Arrows 1-1 in shootouts.
Well, with a 2-minute break here, this will give us a chance to look at our Oshman's game plan. Again, brought to you by Oshman Super Sports USA. Let's go over it, Russ.
Well, defense not too bad. They played a little better defensively, had a couple of breakdowns, and unfortunately that one by Shargorodsky in the third period at center ice where he tried to pinch in along. on the boards, make a check, missed his check. That led to a break-in by San Diego, and that's when Donatelli scored the tying goal. That's why we're going to the shootout. Power play, nothing wrong with the power play tonight. The Arrows had some chances, and they scored. Townsend and Young both scored on power plays tonight. Composure, you know, so-so. I mean, again, they have lost a lead, which was our fourth point, protecting the lead. They had a 3-1 lead in this game in the second period. That lead lasted less than a minute, and it became 3-2. And then here in the third period, 3-3. So those last two points kind of tie in together, the composure and the protect the lead. Whether it was a lack of composure or not, I don't know, but the fact is they did have a two-goal lead, and they don't have it anymore.
So as we're knotted at three heading into a shootout, it'll be Alan Bester against Rob Dobson. The Gulls, being the visiting team, will shoot first. Walt Kyle has to pre-select his five guys and get them ready, and Terry Ruskowski gets his five ready, and Rob Dobson, here's an interesting story with him. You know, after the Denver game, when Troy Gamble gave up two goals right away on the shootout, it was Rob Dobson that came to him and pointed out a couple of things that he was doing wrong. So it's now, quote-unquote, the teacher out there to try and win this one for his hockey team.
And in the next shootout that Troy Gamble was faced with here against Atlanta, he made seven stops and eight chances. And then finally, Graham Townsend won it. So it was good advice, and I hope Rob Dobson takes some of that advice himself. One of these nights we'll have to have an opportunity to talk with Terry Ruskowski as to what his strategy is here. We've seen them go one in regulation shootout and the second into the sudden death of the extra shootout stanzas. But what is your strategy? Do you want your best goal scorer to go first so that you get your team off and running and get a quick lead? Or do you want your best goal scorer near the end of your first five so that if you absolutely have to have one, he's there? Well, who's up first for the San Diego Gulls? It'll be maybe their best, Hubie McDonough.
So here we go. Hubie McDonough, who will have his first chance here on the shootout against Rob Dobson. Puck stays at center circle. The rules are pretty simple. The shooter has to keep the puck moving forward at all times. And all it takes is one chance, and we'll see now as the referee will give his instructions, and I'm sure he'll tell the same thing to Rob Dobson. Hey, the puck has to keep moving forward, and that's that.
In the shootout we saw in the home opener, I was not really all that impressed with the shots that were taken in the shootout. We'll see if there's some better ones tonight. Here's McDonough.
He'll bring the puck now over the Arrow blue line, right in on Dobson. He cuts, shoots, scores! Hubie McDonough. He went upstairs over the left shoulder. Over the left shoulder of Rob Dobson, and the Gulls lead it 1-0. Now it is Murray Eves, a short-handed goal tonight, and he'll move it from right to left. He's going to have to wait so that the directions can be given to Alan Bester.
Great shot by McDonough. We just talked about that. Unfortunately, he came in, went up high.
Now Eves will bring a chance as Bester comes way out. Eves cuts, shoots, and a great save by Bester. And after one shot apiece, it's San Diego 1. And the Arrows nothing. So now it's up to Mark Buffet. He'll move it from left to right as he'll move in on Dobson here. We're tied at 3 in a shootout. Here's Buffet for San Diego. Gallops into the Arrow zone. He's right in, waits, turns, shoots, and it was stopped by Dobson. That one cranked the post, but Dobson will get credit for stopping that. And it stays 1-0, and it's up to Clayton Young.
Best piece of equipment the goaltender wears, the post.
They say it's the best friend that a goaltender ever had. Is Clayton Young. Young with a goal tonight as he crosses the line. Young moves in on goal, shoots, and Bester got the save, and he'll knock that into the corner, and that will keep it at 1-0 in favor of San Diego after two shooters.
I think this is the big one here. I don't like if you got to go into numbers 4 and 5 at home trailing. So as Loach gets set here, Dobson needs the big stop.
Here's Lonnie Loach now. He'll cross the line. Loach cuts in, shoots. Dobson the save. Good stick save by Ron Dobson. And now for Houston, it will be Mario Cittaroni on Alan Bester, who stopped the first two shooters of the Houston Arrows. Let's see how Mario does. Here comes Mario Cittaroni now as he picks up the puck at center ice, crosses the line. Cittaroni moves in, shoots, scores! Mario Cittaroni, top shelf! And we're tied at one after three shooters in the shootout.
Now he went to the backhander, much as Murray Eves had did earlier, but Eves tried to go underneath Bester, and Bester slid over and the save. Ciceroni went up high.
Here comes Ferner now. Mark Ferner. He'll move in on goal. Shoot! Up to the save! And now Mark Freer will go. And I'll tell you what, don't think Scott Arneal hasn't made a factor in this. He probably knows a little bit about Alan Bester, and he's telling him where to go. And now it is Mark Freer. He'll move it from right to left. Freer picks up the puck at center. He'll cross the line. Freer for Houston. Works. Shoots. Bester, a glove save.
He tried to go up high, but he tried it from too far out. The angle was tough, and Bester went right up with him. And so Sacco gets a chance here, and we're really virtually in sudden death at this point.
Here is David Sacco now as he crosses the line. He'll move in on Dobson. Sacco shoots. He scores! David Sacco! And Dobson pounding his pad, saying he felt he could have had that one, but a good shot by Sacco, and it's all up to Scott Arneal to tie and send it into further shooting. Otherwise, it's over. Here comes Scott Arneal. He's got the chance. He's got the puck. He's in on goal. He waits, shoots, scores! Break it up! The top part of the net. And we're tied at two, and we go to extra shooters.
You think that isn't pressure? You're the last guy. The entire building watching you, knowing if you score, there's a life. If you miss, we go home disappointed. That's pressure. And that gets back to the strategy we talked about. Who do you want going first? Who do you want going fifth? He had a veteran, Scott Arneal, going fifth. And Scott Arneal got it by Alan Bester. Now we're in sudden death.
Brian Sullivan, he'll move in on Dobson. He'll wait, shoot, Dobson the save. Why don't you run down and ask Kostkowski what he thinks of it now?
Well, I want to wait and see if Dave Tippett and other veterans can end the night on a winning note. If Tippett scores, we go home winners. Here we go.
Tippett now will pick up the puck at center ice. He'll move in one-on-one on Bester. Tippett cuts in. Deke shoots. Score! Dave Tippett and the Arrows defeat the San Diego Gulls by a score of 4-3. What a play by the 11-year NHL veteran, Dave Tippett.
Well, now you see what happened. We talked about strategy. And what Terry did is start with a veteran who'd already scored once tonight in Murray Eaves. The guy has been around and been a goal scorer and been around a long while. Then he went to some other guys, Young and Ciceroni and Freer. And then he came back, his fifth and last guy, a guy he knew might have to save the night for him. It was another guy who's been around through the hockey wars at various levels, including the very top, Scott Arneal. And he got the goal as the fifth shooter to tie it, send it to further sudden death. And after Sullivan missed, you got yet another veteran in Dave Tippett, the player assistant coach, and he puts it home, and we got a 4-3 win here for the Arrows.
All right, the final tonight, in a shootout, the Houston Arrows defeat the San Diego Gulls by a score of 4-3, and the Arrows up their record to 2-2-1. When we return, we'll have more, including a period recap, right after this.
I'm Larry Forehand. At Casa Olay, you'll taste the delicious difference in our food from the very first bite. Everything at Casa Olay is prepared fresh at each location. Try our tasty chili con queso made with 100% real American cheese, beans and rice prepared fresh daily, and what can I say about our crisp chips and hot sauces? You guessed it, made fresh every day. Now that's a fabulous start to a great meal. So the next time you crave great Mexican food, taste the difference. Casa Olay, fresh today.
The new 95 Gilman Mitsubishi Eclipse is more than just a great performing car. It's the kind of bargain that will stop you in your tracks. Because at Gilman Mitsubishi, you can own it for $189 a month. You'll have to hurry, though, because this special Gilman deal ends Saturday night. Gilman Mitsubishi, Rankin Road, Bel Air Boulevard, and Highway 59 in Rosenberg.
Way to go, Gilman! Way to go!
Feet below the Earth's surface.
And then there were these talking camels and kings and queens.
The elevator didn't go up or down, but sideways like that.
And then I said, Bill, look, those people, they're floating.
And then there was this light, you know? And you could see it all the way from outer space.
It's different on the inside, too. Luxor, get into it.
Hi, everybody. I'm Al LeGrand.
And I'm Chris Katulak, Louisiana Downs track announcer. Join us every Tuesday evening at 6 o'clock on HSE for Inside Louisiana Downs.
Feature races, national races of the week, outstanding stakes events, and we'll take you inside Louisiana Downs for a look at trainers and jocks and really what makes horse racing what it is.
That's Inside Louisiana Downs every Tuesday evening at 6 o'clock on HSE.
Don't miss it. We'll see you.
It's time to jam.
Can you dig it?
Big hits. Big plays.
Big time emotion.
Dig in for the best of the SWC. Saturday on HSE.
Today's Houston Aeros broadcast has been brought to you in part by Southwest Airlines. Flying the low-fare airline is just plain smart. And by Columbia HCA Healthcare Corporation, a new commitment to healthcare together.
Welcome back to the Summit in Houston. Adam Gordon along with Russ Small. And for the second time on these telecasts, Russ, I don't know what kind of presence you bring, but you must like the shootouts, because for the second straight time, the Aeros had to go to a shootout. And they do it again, this time on a Dave Tippett goal, and they win it 4-3.
I'm going to start putting in for overtime here, Adam, if we keep doing this. Five games this year, all decided by one goal. Three of them decided in shootouts. And as I said earlier, the first couple had been decided in favor of the home team. And indeed, that was the case tonight. But it wasn't easy tonight, as McDonough scored right off the bat in the shootout and gave the Gulls a 1-0 lead in the shootout. It took a couple of shooters, Eves and Young, missing before Cinerone finally scored. And of course, Dobson had kept his team in it by making a couple of saves. And so we were 1-1. But then the fifth shooter for San Diego, Sacco, scored. And the Aeros were down 2-1 in the shootout. If Scott Arneal does not score, this night is over, and a disappointing one, but he does. And then when Dobson stops Sullivan, it sets up Dave Tippett for his opportunity.
And that brings us to our Southwest Airlines play of the game, the low fare airline.
Well, you talked about how Arneal had been given tips, and the tip must have been backhanders, because two or three guys had gone to the backhander before Tippett suddenly comes on and goes to the forehander and goes to the blocker side, the stick side on Alan Fester. So I really think, and I'll talk to David about it a little bit later, but I really think that he had watched two or three guys in a row.
Points on 3-2-2 could easily be 10 or 12 or more points if they just held leads and got the 2 points for a win rather than the one for a shootout loss, as they've gotten a couple of times, or zero.
One thing that has been good for the Houston Aeros has been the production of the Mark Freer, Scott Arneal line, especially Mark Freer.
Mark Freer and Scott Arneal, two guys counted on to deliver, and they have been, each with 8 points in the last five games. Freer has the first ever power play goal for the Aeros. He also has the first ever shorthanded goal for the Aeros. We look for Mark Freer to have a good offensive game here today.
Yeah, he already has a goal and three assists in his last two hockey games. It's time for the Oshman's game plan, brought to you by Oshman Super Sports.